longer. I mean,
hey guys, welcome to Board Games with Beta Bros, motherfuckers. We're back. We have a full squad of nerds.
The squad rolls out.
Yeah.
The game crashed.
Wait for me.
Oh, are you fucking kidding me?
It's okay. We can keep going. Tonight, we're playing Robinson Crusoe.
Isn't he recording too?
Robinson Crusoe. And it is a worker placement game starring Doge. So
fucking mean looking dog too.
Is that,
like,
is that a pit bull or a staffy or a bit of both?
It's a golden retriever.
It's a poodle.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it's a spaniel.
So Robinson Crusoe is a worker placement game, worker placement scenario game about surviving on a island.
You're gonna have to do this.
A desert island
for a certain amount of time, and then try and win. It's cooperative. There is no backstabbing.
Then why are we playing it?
Because it's actually
we're still gonna fuck it up.
Because we're still gonna lose. Because the game is tough.
Yeah.
So we're playing the basic bitch version called Castaways, which is the one they always suggest you start with. And we've got easy mode on because we got Doge. What up, yo. Doge?
So what does Doge do then?
No, we've got a better Doge.
So it gives you an extra token to put down on two things.
It's just basically a free meeple.
Yeah, it's a free meeple.
So, oh, God damn it! I forgot to turn off my browser's shit. Thank you for the host, sheepdog, and ruining my recording. Can we do an intro again?
Welcome.
No, we're just going to keep going, because that was perfect. The other thing that we need to do now, everything's already set up. We need to randomly draw a character card. So if you want to go over to this brown bag here and just pull one out. It's all random right now. So just pull one out. You got the missionary.
I like it, missionary.
Wait, you I'm pulled missionary carpenter. From the brown bag? That's not right.
No, it's right.
So what did you got the explorer? Fuck yeah, what do you get?
Can I be the lady explorer or is it
the cook?
Yeah, you just flip. Okay, so we got a cook, we got a carpenter. We're okay then. We're okay. I'm gonna be the lady. I'm gonna be the man carpenter. Cause yeah.
I'm gonna be the lady cook because she looks like she's just all business.
So how do you clone a thing? Is it
Does
control
she have
C?
A white patch?
Yes.
Okay. There you go. Here's a
you
heart
can fuck
token.
Around in her kitchen.
Heart token. No. Heart token. These things start on the first.
Holy
square.
Shit! Those bazungas, though.
Right? She they don't fuck around in her kitchen. She
no,
uses them as a
I will never fuck around in her kitchen.
All right. So yeah. It's
I'll mess around with her pantry. You know what I'm saying?
Damn. So basically, each of us will get two meeples. At the start. So if you want to find your meeps,
I'm Mr. Meeps.
And everyone
what do I
gets
look like?
Everyone. Well, you're just a dude. It doesn't matter which one, really. Like you'll be, you're the you're that guy. Yep. And everyone will get a free technology as well. So the carpenter gets a snare. So I'm not sure. I'm not sure where we pull them from. I think we pull them from.
They would be in here, wouldn't they?
Let me search for a snare.
A bibli.
No.
Yep. That's a spear. Sling. I don't know where they are, actually.
Where are the actual... Would they be in here?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I don't know where they are, actually.
No, here it is. Here it is. Snare.
Where'd you find it?
Snare.
Oh, where'd you find
it? In the inventions. Oh, they're in the inventions. What does the carpenter start with? Where do you see that, actually?
It's on the right. I've got a snare.
Oh, fireplace. So I start with the fireplace. So there's mine. Cheapy, what do you start with, Mr.
Diary.
Missionary? You start with a diary.
I start with a diary.
You're pretty tank. Diary. You're pretty tank for a fucking...
And you start with a shortcut.
Yeah, you got a big ass belly.
There you go. Have a shortcut.
So I was thinking about it, and I think we do need to pull a adventure at the start because there's only 12 of them, and there's only 12 days, 12 months. So, So yeah, let me.
No, that's this one here.
Yeah, no, but there's 12 left. So, yeah, no, we got to go through all of them. So, so this is scenario one. You are castaways on a desert island, and it is the end of summer. You have to prepare for winter, build shelter, a roof, and a palisade. It'll be difficult to survive during the tough months of autumn and winter. You also have to build a pile of wood so you can light it on fire when you spot a ship on the horizon to call for help. So if you take a look over at this castaways table over here, you see these last three turns here, they have a ship. So if we can build a big bonfire, which is this cube here, we have to build, how much is it?
15.
We have to build 15 pieces of wood in here by the last 3 months of the year. And if we can do that, we win without dying. Also, we lose if any of us die. It's worth pointing out. So there's no...
Yeah, okay. If one person dies, we all lose.
Yeah, we all lose. So... Yeah, so the goal of scenario is you must have built fire item and a pile of wood box on the right by the 10th, 11th, or 12th turn. Wood cubes can only be placed before the action phase, from left to right. You can put any number of wood cube on the pile, but no more than one column per round. Succeed in this and you win. So I guess we can start off with the bottom columns. One.
And, columns, yeah. So... one, and then we put two, then we put three, then four, then five.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes more sense.
Oh, you start with one. Okay.
Yep. And we can only put one per round, so we have to build up to it. And the action phase, I believe, is the fourth one?
Four's resolve actions, so yes.
Yep. All right, so there's a couple phases that happen. The first one is an event phase, which is we draw another event down here. So the simple math of this game is pretty much you have two of these tokens, right? And every turn you get to decide where you want to put them. So let's say you want to explore over here. You put your guy over here, and then you would have to roll these explore dice here, right? So the three icons that you need to look at here is right now, see this Y thing? This is the Robinson Crusoe logo. That means you succeed. Okay. Where is another one? This one here means you get inspiration, which is morale, basically. So
that's these tokens down here, by the way.
Yes, it is. Yeah. So it's
those. So is that two, or does that just mean one?
No, you get two.
You get two. Okay.
So the question mark means, and these die are all different, by the way. So the question mark means you'll be pulling one of these bad boys. And then you have to do it. And these are always pretty much bad. So you don't want to have them.
Always a green one.
Always a green one. But if for example, if you're building, so if I put a build guy here and I build this, right?
Yeah.
I'll be rolling the brown die, which is the same die, but you know, from the brown table, basically. Okay. So that's that. I think that's all that was. And then there's a blank one on there as well. So, yeah, there's a blank one. And this one here is the heart icon. This is basically you take damage while doing whatever it is that you were doing. So,
right.
That's pretty much.
Stub your toe.
Yeah, stub your toe. And see now the heart icon's on your sheet. See how it goes four, then three, then two, then three, or whatever it is. Some of you might be different.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Every time that you pass an arrow that points downwards, you go up to this morale tracker up here, and you would just move it down one. At the start of the end of the night phase, I believe it is. I could be wrong on that. We might need to double check that. I don't know.
Morale
is second phase. Yeah.
Morale is second phase.
Yeah. So if, for example, this cursor here is at one, right? Negative one. That means if you have any of these tokens, then you lose one. If you don't have any of those tokens, you lose health instead.
Okay.
So if these morale is positive, however, you start gaining them at the morale.
Yes, you do. Yeah.
Okay. Do the hearts work the other way? So if I was at like this health and then I healed, would I gain?
No, it only applies the first time you go down.
Yeah.
Going back up for whatever reason won't affect the morale again anymore. And if you go back past it a second time, it won't go down a second time.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
And yes, the way that you avoid rolling this dice is by placing two tokens on the space. So if I wanted to explore but just auto succeed, I would put two tokens there. Now, we have a dog one, a dog token here, which we can decide to put anywhere we want. The dog can help with exploring and with hunting. Hunting is like these animals down here, which will come up eventually. So the dog can like, you know, I can, for example, do this, and then he can help me explore this tile, which is, you know, a good thing.
That's probably good to point out that you don't have to put both of your meeples. There just has to be two of them. So you can put one and someone else can put one.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. The other thing is, this happens, this affects literally everything on this board. So if you wanted to say, do this event, right? See how down here it says for one meeple, you would get one food. For two, you would get a different thing. And the way that these events actually work is, when another one comes out, it'll go here. And then when another one comes out, this one will get cleared. Now, do you see on the bottom of this one how it has like a little flag? If it gets cleared off, then whatever's on the bottom on the flag happens. And it's normally very bad. This is like basically just a starting one because, you know, it's just free food, essentially.
We've just washed ashore and, oh, look, there's some food crates. We should grab those.
Yep.
All right.
And... yeah, so the other things that you can do is you can move your token to research anything. Now, the requirements to research is up the top here. See how it says to research a dam, you need a squiggly water line and a wood. Now,
so we have to have found a river.
Yeah, so basically the way that you find the tile for that is by exploring. And the tiles are randomly generated. The other thing,
we have woods and fish.
Yeah, so the other thing you can do is you can go over here and you can build... the requirements. So every time to build an upgrade, so you, if you wanted to build a camp, for example, you would go here and you'd build. And then you would roll on the brown table, the same as what you'd build down on here. So if you wanted to automatically succeed, you would have two people up there, right?
Okay. And I believe this is the cost at the top, isn't it?
It is, yeah. So for four people, to build one thing, we need to have four wood and three skins.
Is that and or all?
It might be ore. I'm pretty sure it's ore.
I'm pretty sure it is because skins are a lot harder to come by than wood.
Yeah.
So how important is it to get two people to do a thing?
Okay.
Is it like super important?
So let me explain some other things. These icons here are the weather. When we get to turn 4 and 7, weather will start playing a part. So the icons that you need to worry about here are, see these clouds. The clouds represent rain, okay? So that's pretty much like, okay, if we don't, if two clouds show up, you count the number of clouds. So let's say if this one here, right? Let's say that this happened. Then it'd be two clouds, it'd be three clouds. So our palisade roof would need to be three, level three, in order for nothing bad to happen to us. And it will go down by whatever level of cloud it is. So for example, if it's three, then it will go down to, you know, nothing. But if we don't have it, say we're at two and we roll a three, the difference in the clouds, so we would need to lose one food or item or something like that. It's food, actually. You'd lose one food from your stockpile, which is really bad. Okay. The other icon you need to pay attention to here is this little like star thing here that represents how cold it's becoming. So in order to remove the cold, sometimes it's two, sometimes it's one, you need to spend one wood or two wood to make up for the difference. And any difference that we don't have, so for example, if we have one wood in our base and two stars come up, we then need to all of us take one damage as the difference. So it'll be very...
Can you make the choice to save the wood and make one?
No, these will automatically get used. But you can choose to use the wood in other places, right? So, and this one here, this red one, comes in for turn 7. This one here means that we fight a monster. Let's just... a hunt. So basically these monsters, these are the hunts, right?
It attacks us.
Yeah, so the way that this works is... if you take a look here, the skull represents how much damage or health it has.
I think it's just strength in general.
Yeah, strength in general, yeah. I think the next one is how much damage it does to you. Wait, I don't
that's how much it takes off your weapon score.
Oh, okay, right. So.
So yeah, our weapon tracker is up here as well. This is basically how well armed we are.
Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah, we fight. So for example, if we have one weapon score, we the person who's attacking it. It's worth pointing out as well that if, for example, I'm down here and you know Doc is down here as well, we would decide who's the leader, right? So if Doc's the leader and I'm helping him do this, then if we have a difference of one between our weapon and the HP of the boa, Doc would take one damage, not me. So Doc would be the, the leader takes the damage. And if, for example, we have the difference in the weapon damage as well, if it goes down to zero, we would be at one, and it goes down to -2, for example, then everyone who's, or the leader would also take another damage, I think, if that's correct. I'd need to double check that rule actually, but I'm pretty sure that's how that works. So yeah, you need to basically always keep your shelter upgraded. And the way that you do that is by putting your token on there and just sort of spending the time to do it. So you're always going to be taking damage and you're always going to be, you know, getting fucked essentially.
Okay.
And that's pretty much the game. The last thing is we have two starting icons down here. We have a flask of rum, which will give you one HP back. And we have hammer and nails, which is, will help you with a build. And see these white cubes? We can use these two times before they get permanently removed from the board. So.
Okay.
And is there any way to refill these?
No. You just use them once and they're gone. Or twice and they're gone, so.
And what about that question from before? How important is it to have an auto success?
Okay, so yes and no. Some things you can kind of go with. Like this, these here, it says a one person or a two person can go in these ones. So one person, you roll the dice to see if you succeed.
Mm-hmm.
If you've got a lot of inspiration, maybe you can, like, I believe you can use those for rerolls.
Really?
Otherwise, two people is like a guaranteed success. I'm pretty sure inspiration is...
The other thing that's worth pointing out, there are modifiers to these things. So for example, if we get a card that says, okay, you put a -1 meeple on this deck, that means if you want to succeed, you would need to put three people on there.
Right.
But you can't put three people, right? So you can only ever have two people on a space at one time. So you would have to have two people on there to even roll. To even have a chance.
Okay, so on this fail or succeed dice, for this, for example, there are four succeeds and two fails.
Yeah.
So you're more likely to succeed than fail.
Mm-hmm.
But you can guarantee the card at the cost of a second.
You underestimate my dice rolling abilities.
The other thing that's worth pointing out, that when these tokens show up on here, even if you put two people on there, you have to roll, you have to take one of the cards off the top. Yep. So. Now, your characters also have special abilities, that's worth pointing out. You can use one special ability one turn. So you can use all your special abilities once per turn, if that makes sense. So you can use all four in your turn.
But they all have a cost associated.
Yeah, so for example, you can use like your inspiration to do things. So that's what my guy does, at least anyway.
Mine's all about...
Oh, I can gain us morale.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Wait, was Peachy?
Yeah. So mine are like, I can spend mine to reroll any brown die. I can discard three to draw five invention cards from the deck and choose one of them. Discard three to get an additional meeple for building action you take. Oh.
Oh, that's nice.
Sweet.
So I can just have that? Okay, that's kind of cool.
I mean, that does cost three inspiration, so they aren't necessarily cheap.
Yeah.
But if I get three inspiration, do I just get that for free, or is that just a... That's just a building guy, right?
Discard three to get an additional meeple for a building action. So that's these brown, that's inventions, right?
Yeah, so building.
Or construction.
Or construction, yeah. So I can just have a free... That's actually pretty good. I might have to try and get that straight away.
I was kind of thinking maybe like if we try to push the morale up so we get lots of inspiration.
Yeah. So anyway, that's the game.
Anyway.
So now we're gonna who's the youngest here? I think I might be Peachy.
You are.
Me?
You?
Am I the youngest?
I'm gonna assume so.
I'm 28.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're the youngest.
Okay, well that means I go first, so. And then we go clockwise after that. So, all right, first things first, we shuffle this deck and then we draw our first bad event. All right, so.
Fight.
Yeah, so if this falls off, each player will discard 2 morale. So when you're tired and you don't act reasonably, you need a Snickers bar. So,
Snickers bar would be really nice.
So we can, okay. So what is that question?
So we can choose.
Okay, we can choose one or the other.
Yeah, so. Oh, wait, no, question mark. Wait, that's.
That means it does
activate now.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it does. I'm just going to check that rule real quick.
I think that happens when it arrives. Like we.
Okay, in future rounds, if there are cards on the threat action area, pull the new card, right? Okay, yep. Resolving the event card. Event icon. Okay. Refer to the scenario for the book icon effects. Okay, nothing happens there. Okay. That doesn't really explain what to do with it, though. If the event icon has
so
an
it's
adventure
icon.
Okay,
so it's got the icon. Brown question mark.
Oh,
so we've got
that this. Goes up there. Boom. Yeah. So that goes there straight away.
Yep.
Okay. Nice.
Resolve the event effect of the card. And place it in the rightmost space. So everyone takes 1 damage.
Straight away. Right.
Yep.
Great.
After this, we can have put someone here to give a rousing speech, and we'll discard this card, and everyone will gain an inspiration. If we don't resolve this and it gets pushed off, everyone will lose 2 inspiration.
All right, so Sheepy and Peachy, make sure you mark your health. Up mm-hmm. 1.
Up 1?
Yeah.
Down 1.
Down 1, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so now we do inspiration, so nothing happens. Cool, great.
Morale is at 0.
Yep, and now we take turns placing tokens. So I got to go first. So what do I want to do here?
Are we doing one at a time, or are we doing everyone places both?
No, we can do one at a time, I think. No, we'll do both, because then the turn order swaps every turn. So okay, all right, so I think the seller might be very useful.
Oh, actually, that's the thing we forgot. We start at camp with 1 mud and 1 fish.
Oh, yes, true.
So that's 1 mud and a perishable food is the bananas.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think it might be worthwhile building the shovel.
I mean, it's kind of like the staple of all tools, right?
Yeah.
If you have a shovel, you have an axe, you have a knife, you have a hammer. You got all of it right there in one tool.
And I don't think it's worth putting 2 people on there because we already have that question mark on there. So there's no point doing that. And I think... So here's the other thing that's worth pointing out too, guys. Let's say I build the shovel, right? And it gets built.
Yeah.
Then it will go up into this spot up here. Right, which means that we can't use that until the next day. And the same thing goes for any food that you collect.
Yeah, any resources you collect on this turn aren't available for use until next turn.
Yeah,
basically.
All right.
So that's all that means. So I'm going to put 1 dude there. And for my second dude, I think what I will do is I will explore. And I say it's worthwhile taking the dog out with us because we don't have any hunting things yet.
Yeah, fair enough.
Probably a good idea.
Alright, so Sheepdog, you're up, mate.
So if I...
Oh, we didn't point these out either. If someone goes here, you can choose to either take 2 inspiration or increase morale by 1. And if you go here, you can recover 1 heart.
Wait, how do you go to these places?
You just put a token there.
Just put your meeple there, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I'm guessing there's 1 slot, though. So
no, you can... Yeah, so it's...
actually, slot. Yeah, no, anyone, you can... I think for the healing, you can go as many times as you want.
Yeah, yeah, but for example...
Yeah, for the rest... Oh, no, for a range camp, place as many pawns as you want. So, yeah, no, they're both as many as you want on each of them.
Okay, So if I go here, yes.
Yep. So that will, at the end of the turn, get us one perishable food.
And then, so, for example, we can't get, like, the dam, because we need a river in the woods.
That's right, we need to have found a river first.
Okay.
So the other thing that's worth pointing out, it's very useful to get a camp.
Yeah.
Getting, a little bit of construction going.
So we don't have a camp right now?
No, we don't have a camp right now.
No, we're just standing on a beach.
I'm in for a camp then, so.
Okay.
Okay, so just so you know,
wait, can we do that? Because we don't have the wood, do we?
No, we don't.
No,
have the
we'll
wood,
need
so.
We need 4 wood or 3 hides to do any construction.
So I need to go.
No, you can't. You can't.
You can. Where's search for resources? He can search here, can't he, for resources? Isn't it?
You can go there and you can get resources.
He'll get a wood and a fish, isn't it?
Okay.
Let me just double check that. Okay. I think you get it when it gets pulled out, right? So.
So the ones where the camp are, we get them. Every turn.
We get them every turn. So, but we need to build the camp first. So I'm not sure how to get the wood.
Hunting, build. Oh, gathering resources can be taken either 1 or 2 pawns. See below for further details.
Players get gathering resources during allows the production a player to gain... phase. Based on the resources.
For gathering resources, place the pawns above the one specific source on the island tile from which they are gathering. Yeah. Only above one source. So you can either place it over the wood or over the fish, and you'll get one of those.
Yeah.
All right.
And so we don't resolve that until
end of turn. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah. All right. So that's your dude. So Peachy, where are you putting your people? Hey, did you mute yourself, Peachy? What's going on there, man?
Oops. I'm gonna get some inspiration.
Okay.
From there.
All right.
And from here.
Okay. Cool, yeah.
So I get 2 inspiration and everyone else gets extra 1. On the end of the...
Wait, what? No, what does everyone else... Oh, for this, for the speech. Okay. Yeah, cool. All right, so I... Fuck it. I'm going to increase our morale track by 2.
Okay, so now we do resolving, so... we'll go in order again, so let's resolve my stuff first. So let's do the shovel, I guess, straight up.
Yep, doesn't cost you anything, and you have a shovel. Well, you might get a shovel.
Yeah, we'll see. Yep, that's good, I take a heart.
Shovel, and he got hurt. So this, it goes up in here, and it will be available
But
turn.
I still have to flip a thingy.
Yep.
So let's flip that. You have cut your head and are angry. Get 1 damage and 2 inspiration. Put... Oh, okay. Right.
Oh, damage points. Oh. So that's going to affect certain things you do?
So I have a permanent damage.
Head injury.
Yeah. I get 2 inspiration, though, for that. So that's kind of cool, I guess.
He's like really mad. He's like, fuck this. I'm going to build this shovel and it's going to be the best and I'll show you all.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not incompetent. I swear.
Do I pick which one I want?
No. So you take the first one is the event that happens.
Yeah.
And then during the next draw phase, you've got a headache. You have a big bruise on your head and an enormous headache. If you don't have medicine, the character with the head injury on his head gets 2 more damage and he discards that head injury and draws another card.
Draws another card? Oh, I guess from this
book? Just
draw
another card.
I don't know what card is, but okay.
Wait, does that go down here into the events thing? Is that what that is? No.
No.
Wait. I'm pretty sure it's during the event phase you do that, but why would it draw another card? That seems like really fucking painful.
Yeah, that's really fucky.
Does that mean you can discard that to draw another card?
Resolve only when you draw this card during the event phase. Okay, so I don't have to do the headache stuff.
It wasn't an event, was it? It was you drew the card for fixing the thing. So does that icon mean...
So if, for example, we draw one of these cards during an event, we would do the headache part.
And get the headache, right.
Yeah.
So, and this goes back into the event deck now?
No, this gets discarded, I think.
It says shuffle into the event deck.
Oh, yeah, it does. It gets shuffled back in. So later on, the headache might come up and cause you trouble.
No, that's not an event, though.
Oh.
Isn't this the event?
Oh, I see how that works now.
No, no, these are the construction events, aren't they?
No, it gets shuffled into the event deck. It literally
You're right. So now it's, so we need to find medicine before that comes up. Otherwise, he's going to get a ton of damage. And that's why it says draw another card, is so that we still have the same number of events per turn.
Yeah, I don't know where this thing is. Cut head, this one. Okay, so that goes into the event deck. Okay. Alright.
And you took one damage as well.
Yeah, I did. I'm at 3 now, so... Alright, so that's that. And now we do the explore, which we do for free, so... Oop. Cool, we got a mountain pass. And we got a temporary camp there too, which is good.
Yay!
So, what time...
So yeah, if we're here, this is considered a camp level 1, right? Like just a house.
Yeah, it's natural camp, yeah.
Yeah. But that requires us to move our campsite to here.
Which we can do at the end of the night, so...
Yeah.
In the night phase, so we can definitely just move in there, and I think that would be better.
Well, also, it won't cost us anything to do
that
it.
That goes in there, I think.
Yes, there is a wild creature here.
Is that a one-use thing, or can I do it in my turn every time?
What?
Oh, it costs me 2 inspiration. Never mind. Okay.
Yeah, no, it has a cost attached to it, but you can do... Yeah. You can use all 4 of your skills, but you can only use a skill once per turn.
Right.
If that makes sense.
At a hefty.
Well, the parrot is basically food. So.
Yeah, any animal is considered a.
Except for the hunting food. Icon. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Peachy, you're next. So let's do your. What do you want? You want to go to the event track, or do you want to just get to?
The dock when the
Sheepy,
event track.
Sheepy. Sheepy is next.
Sheepy is next. Yeah.
Oh, sheep.
Mine's pretty simple though. It's just food and.
Yep.
So yeah, you get wood, which is up there now.
So we gain there and a food. Done. And so because this is done, it gets taken off and.
Okay.
Yep.
Discarded. Cool.
Goodbye.
All right, Peachy, you're up, mate.
So I'm gonna get 1, 2.
So you're getting 2 of those.
That one over there, and everyone gets
Wait,
1.
Wait, have we done the morale phase?
No.
That's at the start of the turn.
It's at the start.
So it hasn't. Yeah.
So discard this card and get everyone gets 1 morale, I guess. So great.
Wait, we do?
Yeah, everyone gets 1
is
morale.
Is it everyone or is it the person that went there?
It says everyone, doesn't it?
It says discard.
Just discard
no,
this
I was
card and
the
get
bottom.
1 inspiration.
Yeah.
I would assume it to be everyone. I mean, he's giving a rousing speech to everyone. Isn't that?
Yeah. I mean,
we would all gain inspiration.
But I don't know.
It literally says each player gets a broken heart, though, in the top one. So I'm just going to assume that's only Peachy that gets it.
Too. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, at least we didn't
lose to inspiration. It would specify if it was each player, so you're right.
Yeah, he's like, that speech went well.
All right. And you're just going to bump our event track twice?
Morale track up to 2.
Yeah. Cool. And now we do weather. So no weather, which is good. We move this up now, boop, and we do night phase. Now, do you want to move the camp? I believe we can just move it.
Yeah, normally moving the camp, you suffer half your structure in damage rounded up, but we don't have anything. So we may as well move over here and at least have a free house.
Sure.
Although the difference would be if we stayed here, we'll gain a wood and so a food.
I have a snare. Does that just automatically activate? Like, how does that work? Do I have to pay for it?
I believe you have to pay the inspiration cost to place it.
Yeah, okay.
And it adds plus one food to the tile with the camp on it.
That's actually pretty decent. So, yeah, let's move.
Yeah, that's not bad. That's like just one free food every turn for the rest of the game.
Yeah, but I want to get that extra handyman thing first.
Did we do this? Because we will be losing out on a free wood every turn by moving.
Oh. And there's also an animal there.
Well, I mean, yeah. Well, we're getting food anyway from this one. Do you want us to just stay there then?
I think we probably should, just because the free wood every turn at this point is probably more valuable than a level one house.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
We don't have weather effects or anything at the moment. I don't think we're going to get attacked by anything nasty. That's just my way of thinking. The free wood might be better.
Great.
We were at the morale phase, weren't we at one?
No, we went up twice because he had
started
two.
Zero.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
All right. So, okay. Yeah, we can stay there. I'm happy with that. That's not a problem.
Wait, no. Because I'm supposed to get one inspiration during the
You have to spend.
You have to actually activate the diary. Okay, yeah.
Wait, you have to spend two inspiration.
He spends two, and then that becomes active.
Basically. Yeah, it'll flip.
These are normally these cards would be up when it's here, like and that, you have to buy them.
Yeah, when it's like that, it's active, and when it's like that, it's not. So
I see. It's an investment.
Although he does still need the one hide. He doesn't, because he's got to pay the inspiration cost.
He just has it. Yeah. So
okay, I see.
Okay, so night phase happens, and everything comes down.
Yep.
So, and how do we do the food thing? I forget. It's per person, everyone has to eat, I believe.
Okay, it's...
We didn't have enough food, so someone has to take 19. Two damage.
Weather, night phase. We've only got... During the night phase, each player needs to eat. Discard one food per player. If you don't have enough food for everyone, then decide which players do not get to eat. Each player that does not eat gets two wounds. I don't think Henley should take any, because he's already been beat up there.
Yeah.
We have two food, so two of us are going to take a hit. I think I can take one. Maybe not, because I'm really close to dropping on the morale track. Mine are really short.
I'll take a hit.
Yeah, and I'll take one.
It's not a hit, it's two. So you have to go up to...
Yeah, you lose.
What,
lose
each of us cards. Get two?
Yes.
I'll take the hit then, Henry.
Okay.
Oh, you're taking both of them?
No,
he's taking one, and you need to take two as well. Two people are not eating.
And you get two damage for not eating.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
I mean, look at me. I can afford to not eat for a day.
I don't know, man. You kind of...
Okay.
You kind of look like you might eat the Explorer.
Event phase. Alright, Howling at the Moon. Yay. Draw three beast cards from the beast deck. Choose the one with the greatest strength and put it on the top of the hunting deck. Okay. I think that might be an alligator.
Fuck me. Or gorilla. The gorilla.
Well, the gorilla has more food attached to it, so I feel
the gorilla has a higher strength. Damage, so I would assume that's the strongest one.
Yeah.
Oh no, they're both
say strength. It says strength, doesn't it?
Yeah. So they're both six. So then if we look at the next thing, it'd be the gorilla with three damage, whereas the alligator does two.
I'm gonna put the gorilla because we get more reward for killing it too. So.
Yeah. I figure that's an easy way to figure out which way it'd go. Is just look at the next number that's worse.
Perfect.
Okay. When this falls off. Draw the top card from the hunting deck and fight the beast. Oh shit, that's not good.
So we have to fight it.
Put the top card from the hunting deck to the bottom and get inspiration. Discard this card. Okay, we already have a campfire.
We need fire to do that though.
Hmm.
I don't have that yet.
So you have a fireplace. You could turn that on, I think. I think that wouldn't be so bad to turn on.
After the morale phase, we can, because we'll all get to inspiration.
Okay, alright. So, now it's morale phase, so everyone gets two inspiration.
Okay.
Do we have to move that at all, or, how does that work?
Nope.
Okay.
It'll move as things... Oh, shit! No. Oh, hang on.
What?
Doesn't taking damage cause morale loss? No. Oh, no, that's when it gets past the thing.
That's why they have the arrows there, so.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Then we go to the placement phase. I think I'm going to buy my handyman for 3. So I just get an extra token to use, but only on brown things, so that's good for me. Where's my handyman icon? This one. Cool.
That's for a building action you take. Is that permanent, or is that only for this round?
I don't know. I think it's permanent. For a building action you take. Because if that's the case, it might be better to use the snare then.
Where's the threat action field?
What?
That's this here.
Yeah.
Okay.
What is it? What's your thing? Discard 3 to discard any card from the threat action field. I believe that's this one.
Alright.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna look that up real quick.
Yeah, it doesn't say for, like, to gain an additional building dude. It says just for a building action.
Yeah.
Where's the
handyman? Discard 3 determination tokens to get an additional brown pawn that can be used, that can only be used for the building action. This pawn should be discarded after the action is completed. So it's a one shot.
Okay, I don't stop fucking touching my shit, you nerds. Jesus Christ.
Sorry, I was clicking back into the window.
So here's what I think should happen. I think I can just hold on to that until I want to use it, which I think I will do. I will hold on to that. So I'm going to go here, obviously, get some heals. And then, is there anything worth? Is it worthwhile just getting more wood? Maybe. I think we need to get food, though. I think food is.
Yeah, I was just going to say. I think we're hurting for food a little bit.
So here's what I'll do then. Actually, I will take this guy and put him back, and I will just get one out of here, and then I will buy the snare. And then that will give us a +1 food.
Yay.
So,
Oh, actually, that's something we forgot to do as well, is we gained a wood and a food from our base camp.
Yes. Oh, no, that goes in the top part, right?
No, these ones go in the bottom.
You sure?
So, does that mean only one of us needed to take a hit?
No. No,
this happens like the next morning, basically.
Right. Yep.
During the.
Oh.
Okay, so I'm still gonna go on the healing. And then I'm going to. I don't know.
Oh, and you do skip the event phase for the first round. Production phase is when you get the resources. Players get resources located on the tile where the player's camp is located. Each source. Blah blah blah.
Oh, it goes we weren't supposed to have an event last time.
It does go into the bottom one, but it happens during the event phase. So
it's already done. It's fine. And then I'm going to, I don't know, maybe use some of that rum. I don't know. I think I'll be okay with just one heal. What do you think would be worthwhile doing?
What do we
from anywhere?
What do we have? We have a mountain, so we could get a knife, which would give us +1 fight.
Yeah, that wouldn't be so bad. That's a permanent +1 fight as well.
Yeah.
What's a pot do? Turn a food into a extra food into a heal. Yeah, that's not so bad.
Yeah.
But having the cellar.
The fireplace is probably better. To be honest, I wouldn't worry about the pot because if I activate the fireplace, it turns a food into 2 heals.
During a successful something, you gain 1 resource. Oh, okay. Gather. I think that's what the gray ones are gathering.
Wow, that's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
Do we have this icon, by the way? Because that head will come up soon.
No, we have this one. We have fire.
Yeah.
And knife. And that's it.
Bricks,
yeah.
Pots.
Nope, we don't have that. We can make
basically,
it.
Basically, yeah. Normally, you put one of these. Oh, we have a cellar, yeah. So you put like that there, just tells us which ones we can buy.
These are the mountain. Oh, no.
Look at the mountain icon. It's different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay, so, God, I don't know where to put my last... I just might heal again. No, we've only got 12 turns. We need to be proactive about this shit. So, we're getting extra food. So, So, if I go to this space here, is this like a gathering? I forget what this gray one is.
Are we supposed to draw one of those event cards for gathering? Is that the thing that I'm seeing?
Maybe. Maybe.
So was I supposed to draw one of those?
For no, you're supposed to roll, I think. That's what you're supposed to do. See, this
I
is...
I think he is, yeah. When you take a gathering resources or exploration action on a tile that space that is not adjacent to your... Oh, no, wait, that's for going further than one.
Yeah. So if we're, like, next outside of a camp, basically... action 3
building. Do we need to do that?
When you gather resources, take the appropriate resource from the supply near the main board and put them near the future resources space. You can only gather one resource from each respective island source. I believe he is supposed to have taken a gathering event.
Well, I mean... Okay, explore. Where's the gather?
Yeah, they're the gathering resources. One's here, so
yeah.
So I was supposed to roll?
No, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I mean, we weren't supposed to have a event at the start either, but I did that. So.
Yeah, I figured that makes up for it.
Yeah, right. Let's skip over that, and then next time we'll do it right.
Yeah.
Okay, so we were supposed to gather. When you gather, you're supposed to roll. Is that what's happening? Unless you put two people into it.
Yes. So.
Okay, well, in that case, I'm going to, I don't know. I mean, we can
what
build...
What about this, Henry?
What? Well, we can't do that until we have a fireplace, mate.
Okay. Although, the, to be fair, the gather thing only has, like, a 1 in 6 chance of not succeeding, so it's pretty simple to pull off.
Isn't Doc going to get the fireplace on his turn? So when this is triggered...
Can we put a
fireplace? No, because the fireplace won't be available until next turn.
Can we put a wood up here?
Right, yeah.
Let's put a wood up here. When did we do that? When can we put the wood up there? Before action phase.
Before the action phase.
Okay, so let's put a wood up there. Otherwise, because we can only do one per turn, right? So
actually, yeah, we may as well, because these are really easy to do now, so we may as well get them kind of going.
Okay, so, Jesus Christ, I don't fucking know.
One per turn, not one per round.
I'm going to actually, look at building the palisade, I think. Because that kind of needs to get done, started. Do we need to build a camp first?
I would say don't build the palisade quite yet.
Well, we kind of need to, dude, because we've, next turn, well, in two turns, we have to, we're going to get, all our shit's going to crash.
But I kind of want one wood.
What for?
I was thinking I would activate the fireplace and build a hatchet.
Okay.
Plus one wood on the tile with your camp, so we'll always be getting an additional wood per turn.
Well, we don't have a camp, that's what I'm saying.
We do.
We have the camp, we just don't have a hut.
Okay, alright, fine. So what now? What are we doing then? What am I doing then? I can't do anything.
I don't know, what are you doing?
I guess I'll go build the knife then. Shit. Alright, that's my turn.
I mean, that works.
Okay. I think I'm going to heal and explore with Doggo.
I mean, he can help you fight as well, just an FYI.
Well, but just, I don't think he would want to fight the gorilla quite yet.
Yeah, I wasn't really thinking fighting
the gorilla. You'll just straight up take 6 damage if you fight the gorilla, because we don't have any tools, any weapons.
So, Peachy, you're up, mate.
Do we want me to increase the inspiration track?
If we get the inspiration track up one further, you can choose to take 2 inspiration, or you can choose to heal a wound at the start of the round.
That's why I was wondering.
Okay, yeah, do that. That's fine.
Wouldn't be terrible.
So that costs me 3 to do that.
Wait, what?
Do that now?
You can just do that.
No.
When do I do that?
You can just move to this thing over here, and you can choose to either take 2.
No. He's got a special ability. He's got a special.
Ability. No, look.
You can do that. Yeah, you can do that whenever you want. So just
discard 3 to increase by 1. Oh, okay. Well, if you want to do that, sure.
Yep.
And then I was also going to activate my shortcut as well.
Well, hang on. Wait till we resolve, because that has a camping spot on there and we might need to move up later. So ideally what you want, right, is you want to put the shortcut back on this place so we can get one wood and move into this one. You know what I mean?
Well, it's adjacent, so I can put it there from this camp.
Well, we haven't moved the camp, though. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, do the camps disappear?
During the production phase, you get one chosen resource available. Oh, so if he puts it anywhere, he can just always be taking...
Yes, but we have to move the camp first. So if we move... So, yeah. For example, if we move...
Yeah, I see what you mean, yeah. If you put it here, we'll be getting a free food, right? But if we then move the camp over here, your shortcut doesn't do anything anymore.
Oh, I thought our camp moved to there.
No, it didn't.
No, this X here represents the camp.
I see. Okay, then. So, I will move...
Are we going to murder us?
No.
Are we still shitty for wood? Should I go and try and get some wood?
Yeah.
We're going to have one wood left at the end of this round, and we're pretty low on wood. We do need a lot of
food,
wood, that's why I kind of want to hatch
it. Food is low as well. Shit.
Yep.
Well, I mean, I could put them both on here, right, and get a food and a fish, a food and a wood.
So, if we get, for example, if we get this dam, do we just get two food out of that? Is that how that works?
Two non-perishable foods, yes.
Okay. Oh shit! A furnace might actually be very useful later on.
So is that just a one-off with the dam, or is
it is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So when you flip it, whatever's on the other side. So for example,
it's available to you.
Yeah. So if we flip this, god damn it! Fuck off! Get off from there. Yeah, we get a knife permanently. So, okay. Yeah. But yeah, we can't even make that because we don't have a river. So.
So which is the. Yeah, okay.
So you can. So here's what you can do. You can go here, for example, or here, and you can just put both your things and just automatically succeed in an explore.
Yeah.
Which wouldn't be so
bad. What about food, though? We've got one food.
Yeah, so that's the problem. Like, you can go here and put both your dudes here and get an additional food. That way you won't have to roll.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Or you could do one and one.
You could do one and search, and like the gather is pretty easy, so you probably will get the food anyway.
Yeah. So it's up to you. Whatever you want to do.
Okay, I'll do that.
So you're going to search and
gather and explore. Okay. All
right, what are you doing, Doc?
Right, so I want to buy the hatchet.
Does this track move up? Yeah. It's moved up, so I need to discard, okay.
Yeah, you need to discard, yeah.
I want to activate the fireplace, so we have fire now, guys. Guys, I discovered fire.
Oh my god! But have you seen this shit?
Have you seen this?
It's better than yo-yos. That's the new roller skates.
So
right there.
I'm a little curious here. When we move camp, do we take all these tokens with us?
Yes, it's on the space where the camp is, not just.
Okay, like, but
not on the space, but wherever the camp is.
But we get one wood from the hatchet?
Yes.
Even though there's no wood tile?
Yes. Okay. We add one of these tiles to it, and it follows the camp around. We have a hatchet, so it's easier to gather wood from.
All right, cool. So that's places, now let's do this. So I gain one health back.
Hang on. I'm also going to gather food.
Oh, you haven't done your thing yet.
Can't you gather food with Peachy there, and that would be an automatic success for both of you? Or
yes, but if I do this, we've got a chance at two food.
Alright, so... so I gained my health back, and what was the other thing I did? Oh, yeah, building the knife. Okay, so I need to roll the brown dudes. Oh, fuck off, Jesus. I'm trying to, drag over this stuff.
No, my diary! Don't read the diary! It's all about how I love God and Jesus.
Hey, all right.
Today I was watching the carpenter work. As you know, I love carpenters.
All right, so that is now a part of this.
And we, that's right. Next turn. That's actually really good. Just a permanent plus one fight.
It's not bad. All right. So, what is next, my friends? Sheepdog.
Me. So I take 2 health back.
Wait, 2?
Why is healing?
You put both your dudes there? You only take 1, wait. Man.
Oh, you only take 1? Okay, yeah. Sorry.
Then it's per token that you get, so.
I take 1 healing back.
And then you explore for free. Yeah.
Then I explore for free, so I don't need to roll, right?
You know, you just take the land. Yeah, here we go. What do we get?
Doge.
Hey, land.
Ooh, sweet.
Oh.
Woods and these things and...
Actually, tiki we didn't tigers. Do that, did we? When we found this thing.
What is that?
No, there's no tiki or anything, so we don't have to worry about it.
No, but Mayan we found the coin and we found the... Yeah, so what? Which one was the coin? That was...
Is that just a treasure?
Is that one of these? No. Is that a mystery?
Is it a discovery?
I think that's the mystery.
That's a discovery token, yeah. Okay, so we flip that. Okay, that's a...
We discovered.
That is a herbs, plus 1 HP. So I discovered that, right? So...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool, bananas.
So I get 2 for discovering this?
No, yes, you get 2 tokens, yes. So, what have you got? Oh, brown meeple and... What does that do?
No rain.
No rain today.
Okay, so you get a brown meeple next turn to use, so you just hang on to that one. And that one just goes up there, so...
Oh, sweet.
Is that like a one-off use?
Yeah. Yes. And then we add... We flip that gorilla and we put another dude on top. Cool.
Wait, where does the gorilla go away?
It's just second down now. Because you got another tiger here, so.
Yeah.
All right, Peachy, you're up, mate. What do you want to roll first? Your explore or your hunt?
Hunt. I'm rolling a gather. Hunt.
There you go. Roll that die.
Oh, gather. So we just get a food, right?
No. Roll the die.
Oh.
Yep.
Gotcha.
Roll them die and
roll them.
Okay, so we
take a wound and we gather a food.
All right, so I'll put the perishable food.
Those fish are dangerous, man.
All right, now you do
shark. It was actually shark. I was hunting shark.
Don't hunt shark. Flake. Shark's mean.
Now roll them.
Yuck.
Okay, so we succeed. You lose a HP, and this happens.
This happens.
You have found new bamboo sticks in the wood. Decide, discard this card or get 2 wood and shuffle into the event deck.
How badly do we want this wood?
Okay, crack of broken wood. The bamboo breaks and the whole construction... Okay. Oh, no,
we don't have a roof yet.
So, no, yeah, here's the thing. Or... What's that symbol? That's
or
a palisade.
One resource.
No, that's a palisade. That's a palisade.
Oh.
Okay, so we can get 2 wood right now, and then that goes into the event deck and might show up later. I think that's probably worth it.
Yeah.
That's not terrible. The cost to rebuild a thing is a bit high, but... I mean, if we get these 2 now, we can put them straight in, can't we?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm down for that.
Oops. Fucking bag.
Yeah, so take. I say we take the 2 wood and shuffle that in and see what happens.
And can I put that on here now?
That's a bit of a giveaway, isn't it?
No. What?
Yeah. If you look.
Yeah, no, it shows up at the top, yeah. So, yeah. I just hit it like 5 times or something. Yeah, that'll do. So no, these go into
here.
Yeah, they go into there. So during before the event, the action phase, we can do it. And we've already put 1 in this turn, so we can't put any more in there. So
yeah.
Oh, it's round, right? Okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So that's both your dudes then.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he did explore too. So let's see what he found.
Oh yeah. All right. So you get 2 discovery tokens, and we got mountain hills now. Yes.
And another beast.
We have no hill icons though, so that's good. I guess.
Oh. Well, we can't go up.
And what's that? That is a pirate saber.
Pirate saber, +1 fight.
Cool. So there we go.
Nice.
Boom. Cool.
We can't go up the track, can we? So.
No, it's maxed out.
Oh, do these get discarded now?
Yes, just chuck them over there. Yeah, because there's only so many discovery tokens. Yeah.
Is that Pirate Saber Forever's?
Well,
no.
Until
you fight something, okay, let's just draw one from here, for example. If you fight the Jaguar, well, that's a bad example because it doesn't actually damage anything.
Why are you taking all this cool stuff from the top, man?
Okay, there we go. Wild Pig. So the pig will do 3 damage to the person that fights it, and the swords will go down by 1. That's no matter what.
And if, yeah.
If you have damage, if you have a like fight equal to its damage, it won't hurt you. And the greater the difference, the less damage you'll take.
Also, if it does damage to our weapons and we don't have any, you take damage anyway.
Yeah, you take like half damage instead.
So you get a food. That's a perfect, right? You rolled 2. No, that's 1. So you're going to roll food. There you go.
I need to roll now. So food.
Oh.
Get. But while I was finding food, I also found a pirate's chest.
Discard this card or draw 2 mystery cards. Only resolve
treasure. That's these ones here.
Yeah, they are, yep. And shuffle into the event deck. This round, each player only has 1 token available. Oh, okay.
I think that's all right. We've got a Doge and Sheepy's. Well, those two
things might help us quite a bit, though. We don't know what they will be.
They might, but that's really bad luck.
Yeah.
That's losing an entire half turn, basically.
You decide.
Well, it's not half a turn. It's just 1 meeple, right?
It is, yeah.
Yeah, but
you can still do all your other stuff.
Each player only has 1 meeple, so that's taking 4 meeples off the board, basically, for 1 turn if this shows up.
I think it's worthwhile trying.
Yeah, I think.
It is only resolved treasure. So okay, fuck it.
But bear in mind, I was always the open the box guy.
No, you just flip until there's treasure. So that's a trap. That's a treasure. So that one's fine.
Trap. This is or draw 2 mystery cards and only resolve treasure. Oh yeah, because they're not being resolved, so they're just being immediately discarded, aren't they? Yep. All right. So I found a ceremonial bowl and a helmet.
Congratulations.
I get a yellow reroll. On my character card, starting next round, you will have to reroll 1 result per action, shuffle into the event deck. This is curse 2. Oh, okay, so the curse is it just removes the free reroll. Alright, that's pretty good.
Draw another card. What does draw another card mean? Oh, that goes into the event deck.
That's because it's because this goes into the event deck.
When you use it,
always have to have an event going on.
Yeah. Put this.
Starting next round, each time a player fights a beast, he can ignore 1.
Oh, that's. Is that only once I use the bowl
no,
that
no,
it goes
no,
in?
No, you get this. You get a token, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you get
so
a
that
token.
Goes in there. And this one, starting next round, each time a player fights a beast, he can ignore 1 damage. Okay, that's good too.
Sweet.
So we just put that somewhere. I don't know.
This needs to go back in the deck as well, right?
No. The pirate chest goes
into the event deck as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Hurrah.
Okay. Great. All right. So, that's the you had a build.
Oh, and we gain 1 food.
No, and then you also had a build that you needed to do.
And we built the hatchet. We get a +1 wood on the campsite.
Yeah, but you need to roll
after
for that.
After a roll thing.
Yeah.
Nope, you failed.
Oh, I got wounded. I did get 2 inspiration, though. Can choose to reroll.
Yeah.
Any die. So you can reroll that. That means you can reroll. No.
You can reroll. You can
reroll the success or not.
You can reroll this one.
Yeah, I can reroll this success option die.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to re-roll it because honestly, it can't actually get worse. There we go. There so I succeeded, and we have a hatchet now, guys.
Yeah.
Wait, do you get to keep that permanently on your card, or is it you use it and it discards?
No, you can use it once a turn.
I can use it once per turn. So I've used it this turn now. I won't be able to use it again until next turn.
Great. So now we get a hatchet, right? So.
Yep. So we add the +1 wood token to the camp.
Cool. Great. All right, nice. And now we go to weather, which is just a white die, I believe. No, it's nothing yet.
No die until round 4.
When I got food from here, was I supposed to get an extra food on top of that? Because
no, you'll only ever gain 1.
That's during camp phase, so.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, now nighttime phase. Do we want to move the camp? I think it might be best to move the camp now. Because we got that shortcut that we can use.
That, I mean, that might not be a bad idea now. Yeah, we are getting plus wood. We can move the camp and then use the shortcut to get wood that way.
Yep, and so we also then
getting plus camp. So, and we have the free house.
Yeah, I like that.
Okay.
Plus wood.
This is a bad place to have it anyway.
Yeah.
There's more adjacent tiles.
Okay, and now we do an event. This one goes down here.
Or about the inspiration track, is that last or?
That's
at the start of the next.
So
right. Hang on. So we do these as well first. So we move these down.
Yeah. Oh no! Now we do food as well. We eat.
Yep.
So we only have three food. So
someone's going to take a hit.
If I take a hit, we'll go down the inspiration.
I can take one.
Okay.
Yeah, I can take a hit.
I think Doc's better off taking the hit.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll take the hit.
Plus, you can. Okay, so we get rid of all the.
I have options for healing, so it's not terrible.
Okay.
Wait, is that only you get the healing? I guess.
No.
Anyone can convert one food into two health using that.
Yep, but we need food. So before when can we do this thing again? It's before action phase. Okay. So after we've placed all our tokens, we can put some wood in there. Yep. So I'm gonna. So the knife goes up a track, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it can't go down past one now. All right. Okay. So I'm going to. Oh, now it's the next day. We got our event out, so let's flip that. The first player only has one available token this round. Have vertigo.
Ouch.
What does the book represent again?
Nothing in this turn. Because were we supposed to move the event, this first person thing around? I think we were, yeah.
We were, but we kind of just went with it.
Okay, whatever. That's fine. I'll just not use...
I mean, if you keep it, then you're going to be possibly hit with more things because first person cards.
Yeah, and I can always just spend three and just, you know, whatever. Handyman. So.
Okay.
All right, so that's fine. If we lose, each player discards a thing. That's not so bad. Okay, cool. All right.
Oh, we didn't add our nighttime resources. We got two food and a wood into here.
Two food and wood, yeah. There we go. Perfect. And now... Wait,
we get two foods?
Yes, because there's a parrot there. So.
Ah, parrot. Do we also get another? No.
So now, everyone, you can either heal or you can get two inspiration.
I am going to heal because I'm so close to losing inspiration.
I'm going to take two inspiration, so...
I'm gonna heal. I want the inspiration, but I'm gonna heal because I'm way too close to losing morale, and it's nice having that.
Wait, do you get two bonus. HP? No, it's only one HP you get back. So. It's only one. Yeah.
Oh.
Balls. Yeah, that's not as good. Actually, in that case.
Can you make food with your inspiration?
I can, but it costs me three inspiration to get one food.
But that so essentially gives you two HP, man.
Yeah, but I don't have three inspiration, and I won't.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean...
I think you should heal, Doc. I feel like you should.
Well, if I don't eat... If I heal and I don't
eat, I'm still going to lose morale. Get two morale and use your grandma's recipe.
That still costs a food.
And we don't have food yet.
And he doesn't have inspiration. Oh, right, yeah.
Oh, no, he would get two.
I do have inspiration for shortcut next turn. Yeah, this turn.
Okay, cool. I think we should definitely get food, though. That's just me.
All right, I'm going to heal. Done.
Okay, great. Okay, so my turn. I only get one dude. I'm going to spend three and get a bonus builder. Wait, is there anything I can build this turn? I might build the palisade, actually.
Rope, fire.
I might build the palisade.
We don't really need the fire.
We kind of do, though, don't we?
I have fire.
Yeah, but for this.
But what about for the warmth?
Yeah, it doesn't consume fire. It's just we have the technology of fire now.
Yeah, and we have the
technology. Oh, okay, so we don't need the fire because you've got the fire.
Yeah.
So that still counts as a fireplace for...
Yep.
Yeah. So
should we flip that fire, or does that give us extra if we got it?
No.
It gives us extra of this.
Yeah, it gives you a different thing.
It does give us a palisade, which isn't terrible, to be fair.
And I'm not sure, because it has the actual symbol of the fire there.
Spinning three. I'm going to...
Yeah, this is a fireplace, not a fire.
Yeah. No, look at the actual other side of it.
When you've bought it.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah, okay.
Okay.
So I'm going to move my dude up here, and I'm going to move my...
Would that mean that we just get rid of this and have a different one?
Hang on, now that I think about it, maybe that doesn't count as fire, because that says it requires fire to make. I get to make it for free because it's my starting card.
Yeah.
But it doesn't give us fire.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
So I guess we still do need fire as a technology to use the fireplace.
Well,
but we can
still more worried about rain right now, because I know rain's going to fuck us up. Here's the thing, guys. Nighttime phase the weather phase happens before nighttime phase, and if it rains, we lose all the food. That's what I'm going to say. So.
Yeah.
What doesn't happen this turn?
No, it happens next turn, so it's going to be a problem. So that's my turn, I guess.
Oh. Okay. How worried are we about this?
By the way, it's going to cost me four wood
to build a roof,
so we're not going to be able to add anything.
Wait, did we take the bamboo?
Yeah.
No,
doesn't
we
that
didn't.
Give us
no.
a free roof?
We...
Oh, no, that gave us free wood, and the roof can break. That's, sorry.
I don't know if we took the wood, though. No, we
did.
Yeah,
I did. I put it on the thing.
Yeah, we did.
What's up, Sheepdog? What are you doing?
So, the fire wouldn't be available anyway until next turn, right?
Yeah. No. You'd have to build it, so.
Yeah, so it's not worth, because
it's going to go away, yeah.
So that's not worth doing.
But we're going to have to fight the top deck from the top beast from the deck if that goes away. So it's going to be rough, but you know.
Yeah.
You've got a free...
We have two sword to fight.
You've
so
got
it's
a...
not terrible.
Here's what you should
if you
be doing.
Put two
right?
on it, you get auto success, though.
No. Here's what he should do. He's got a free meeple, right? He should go to the fight, because we're going to have to fight whatever comes out.
Wait, how do I
that
build
does cost a fight? That does cost a wood to increase weapons.
One wood? And you're already using all the wood, so.
Okay, well that sucks.
I could do an explore and a explore with the dog. Maybe.
We need more fucking food tiles, Jesus. A hunt gives us food though, doesn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, you get a
food.
So, although it will be perishable food though, so it will go bad at the end of the next round.
If Sheepy only put two meeples on this, right? He can't put his actual one there.
No.
So if I get food and then I go exploring with Doggo.
Well, I honestly think it might be worth trying to kill some of these things now.
Killing things is a good like sudden burst of food.
I think it might be better to kill. So I think what you're better off doing is just doing that, honestly.
Doggo can fight.
The dog will help you fight. So basically what that means is you won't... What is helping a fight actually do, though?
I don't know, because there's no...
There's no
successful fail rolls.
Yeah. I'm going to look this up real quick.
I'm checking it. That's building, gathering. Who's hunting?
Okay.
Available only if there is a hunting deck and at least one beast card. Hunting allows a player to hunt for food and furs.
Okay, you need to have two pawns to even hunt.
Oh, it actually requires two. Oh, yeah, because it's not one or two, it's two.
Yeah,
so
it just requires two.
Okay.
So.
And then I'm going to use my building meeple dude to build bricks.
Oh, yeah, no, get that palisade going. Yeah, that's not
bad. Well, I was thinking furnace, actually.
Yeah, no, that works too.
Oh, for warmth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, that's pretty good.
Because that negates one warmth forever then, doesn't it?
One cold, yeah. Mm-hmm.
One cold, yeah.
Okay.
So this is make you colder?
Well, yeah, it's like a concentrated area of heat. It has to get that heat from somewhere. It's sucking out of the nearby atmosphere.
Science.
So it's also worth pointing out that it's going to be good once we get the skins, because we get the sack.
The sack would be really nice.
All right, so Peachy, you're up, mate. What are you doing? You going to build that shortcut, or?
I'm wondering. Yeah.
What does the shortcut actually do? You get, during the production phase, choose one resource available. You get one chosen resource. So maybe make a shortcut to the ocean and get a free food.
Well, I can do it each turn, right?
The beach one has each, so.
No. You buy that once, and then that's that.
So. Yeah. So basically, you discover a shortcut to this place, so we can get one for free, and we can choose them between food or wood.
Wait, don't I need to fight the animal, like, out of place?
Nope. It just gets added to the deck, mate.
Oh, I thought...
It just gets added to the deck.
So when this card gets drawn, a beast card gets put onto the options of things for us to hunt.
Right, gotcha.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So what are you doing, Peachy? Where are you moving?
Should I get the rope so we can get the shield, or do we want more resources, or shall I just explore again?
Exploring is probably not super useful right now. We're kind of, everyone's a little bit hurting. I think
you should go some food. Yeah, I think you should go gather.
Yeah. All right, I'll get some food from there.
So let's count how much we'll have. So we'll have 4 at least. And if you succeed the fight, yeah, we're okay. So we don't need to gather too much more now.
Should I get some wood from this place as well?
Sure. You're going to have to gather twice, though. You're going to have to roll 2 separate things.
Gathering's not that difficult, though, right?
Sure.
No, it's a 5 out of 6 chance that you'll succeed.
You could build the rope or the cellar for the food.
Cellar's not bad, but we don't really have a steady
We don't have an expert
to make use of it.
I am fighting something, so...
If you kill something...
I'm going to build the rope, then.
Yeah, okay. The raft is also going to be very useful at some point, too.
Yeah.
So we can
The shield's going to be quite helpful for...
Because then we can send a meeple out with a doggo and not have to worry about any of that shit. So.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. You're up, Doc. What are you doing?
All right, so I want us to not all starve to death. So I'm going to search for food.
There's no other searching places you can go, so...
Yeah, no, not for food.
Yep.
Oh,
there is food.
But you can put more than one.
Yeah, but that just succeeds at it, right? So you'd be wasting...
No, you're right. It wouldn't,
So you don't roll.
Okay, so I'm not going to search for food.
Maybe actually explore.
Maybe just explore, mate. Let's find more food. That's not so bad.
I don't think there's really... Do we have a river? We don't have a river.
We
can't do much of these things. We could get the cure so that we can solve your headache when it pops up.
That's not a bad idea, I guess. Was that, I'm okay with that. So you're just going to use 2 people?
I'd rather you not take a ton for
What
no
about
reason.
Putting wood on the track?
That happens during... That happens
after. That's a different phase. Okay. There's a lot of phases. It's confusing.
So you got one more thing you can do, so...
I might heal, actually, so that if I don't get food, I don't lose morale. That'll happen at the end of the thing.
Alrighty, so now we do our stuff. So my palisades get built, and we spend 4 wood.
Yay!
To do that. Goodbye, wood. Okay, and that goes back over there. And that goes back into my hand, and that is my turn.
Okay,
Do you want to fight first, or do you want to gather?
I want to gather first.
Okay, so that is the gray box. Go ahead and roll that. Cool.
Nice.
That's nice.
So we that's do... a fucking crit success.
Oh, no, that was food, right? Not wood, so.
That's food, yeah.
Okay.
And now fight. So I just reveal this.
Yeah, just flip the top one. Yep. Okay, it's a bear.
It's a bear.
We go. Okay, so we have. So you take a total of 4 damage.
4 damage.
And that puts us over a morale. So you're up to the next one. Yeah. So our morale goes down.
So we lose a morale.
And down to 2. Oh. Yeah. Yes. But it dies.
We also lose 1 of our fight.
Yep. Yeah. But we get 5 food. Which is good. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep.
And we gain a fur, which is really good because you're going to need that sack.
We get 2 fur.
Yeah, that sack's pretty good.
Oh, I'll put that back. Sorry. That's 6.
Too far. Boom. Nice.
The cellar's looking pretty good now, isn't it?
And that's your turn.
Yeah, this is what I'm saying. We kind of, the cellar's good if we have food to put in it. Yeah.
We do now.
Yeah, well, but you could have fought like a
fucking bear. Expecting like a bird or something. Hey guys, I came back. I found bugs.
A rabbit.
All right, Peachy, you're up. What are you doing? So I'm you need to roll gather.
Food first. Gather.
Yep. Okay, so you get two inspiration and one of these.
Wait. Okay. So what I can do is I can just. Oh no, I don't have enough.
No, you can only do it on your turn. So.
No. It says. Discard three inspiration to discard any card from the threat action field.
Can you move your red hand out of the way? I'm trying to read it.
Sorry.
Discard three things to... A threat? I don't know if that's the threat.
No, sorry. It's discard two inspiration to stop any character from drawing an adventure card when they roll ? On the adventure dice.
Do you want to do that?
I mean, if we're worried about Peachy losing...
We haven't flipped it yet, so it's up to you.
Can I do it after it's been flipped?
No. It's before. Are you sure? They read it. It literally says, stop any character from drawing an adventure card if they roll.
I can re-roll, but there's going to be... It's...
Make a choice, Sheepdog. What are you doing?
I'm sure Peach will be fine.
I'll be fine.
Okay, cool. Great. Plus, I reckon you should spend your two thing and actually get that diary going, because then we can get extra morale.
Yeah.
Alright, decide. Discard this card or get one extra food per player. And so I don't think we need extra food.
I think we should discard this card.
No, I don't think we should.
Dude, we have... All that food's going to disappear.
It's not actually, because I do have a fireplace and we can use it to heal during the night phase.
No, not even that. If we don't have cure, each player gets another heart thing.
We're about to get cure.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so here's the thing. So we have four bananas going for food, and we have four that we can spend on healing to get two.
So, each food is worth two heal.
Yeah, so that means we can put Sheepy down to...
Up.
You can go back to full health, and Peachy can go back to full health as well. That's not so bad.
We're going to have the cure anyway, so this illness is nothing.
Yeah. We're gonna have the.
So, do you want extra food?
Yeah, let's get a food each.
I think it's worth the. I think it's worth it because it's basically for free healing.
Okay, cool, done. Look at all those nanas.
Feasting tonight, boys.
Okay.
Looks like meat's back on the menu.
And now you get a health point back, Peachy. That's where you. Sweet. Oh no, that's not you. That's not you. That's not you.
Oh, that's okay. That's me. I get the rope.
Yeah, well, you gotta roll for the rope.
But yeah.
Roll it up, bitch. Nope, and you lose a HP.
I'm gonna re-roll.
With what? What do you got?
Oh no, it's green action. I need to be doing green shit more, because I can re-roll that.
So,
well, you are the explorer.
So you get two extra thingies, and you lose a HP. Okay. And now
I need to heal so hard.
How difficult is it to build a rope, Peachy God?
Doc, you're up, mate.
Okay, I'm gonna work on
auto-erotic polio. Asphyxiation, okay.
You failed.
I forgot to put the lemon.
Re-roll this.
With what? How you re-roll?
With my token thingy.
Nash.
Yay!
We cured.
So I take a wound, but we cured polio.
How to save a life? That's the cure.
And I'm going to heal one, so that negates the wound I just took.
Is it not?
Yep. Okay. No. Now.
Who sings How to Save
Monday
a Life?
Monday and Wednesday too. Okay.
Thursday.
Okay.
So who
sung How to Save a Life?
That's
the
Peachy
Blunt or some prick.
Sheepy, roll for bricks, mate.
Roll for bricks. I'm gonna lose all my health.
All right, so you get a thingy, and if you want, you can spend the 2 points.
No, I don't want to.
Okay, so flip that shit then.
Papa's got a brand new plan.
Okay. Negative one to Palisade. Shuffle into the event deck. Okay.
Oh, we don't have any Palisade yet.
I think we just take damage then.
That's actually good if it comes up as well.
Yeah. Since we don't have a Palisade, we actually take damage. So, everyone.
Like wounds damage?
Yeah,
wounds. Everyone takes a wound.
I don't know if it's one or two. I'm pretty sure it might be two.
Do we want to come back?
Okay, hang on a second.
Looking now.
Damage in the weather phase affects all players. If you are able to discard food or wood, decrease Palisade level. You must do so for each unfulfilled demand. Player suffers one wound. Okay, yeah. So everyone takes additional wound.
Okay.
All right, and...
We have bricks now.
Now we have bricks, and we have and a cure. Great, so we have four bananas that gets eaten. So I'll put that in the bin, in the banana bin. Okay, now the we have... now we have eight
the
bananas.
The Frey? Who the fuck are the Frey?
Doesn't matter. Now we have eight. So we can... Everyone can basically heal... Fully, I guess.
Yeah, at the cost of one food per two.
Okay, so let me just count how many bananas I need. Let's go for Peachy Sheepdog first because he has the most. So you need one, two, three. You need three nanas. Okay, so that's three. I need two. If I want to go full health, I need two, but I'm just going
to let's
go
just
one.
Get everyone close to full first and see how much without, food we have left.
Yeah, let's not Doc, waste food on half a heal.
Doc needs one, and then how many do you need? You need one,
I need two, but I wouldn't be full.
Did you give me three food?
Yes. Yeah,
and
yes.
I kind of want to go adventuring.
Yes, we did. Okay, so we have one banana left, and then everyone will be at one HP aside from Sheepdog, who's at maximum heals.
Oh, okay.
We have one banana left.
I think maybe just leave that one.
No, it disappears. It's gonna get thrown in the bin, man. Like it.
Doesn't it get destroyed after?
Nope.
We eat.
Nope. It gets destroyed before the morning. So.
Well, we've already eaten.
Yeah, I've already eaten. I've already taken the four out.
Doesn't it get destroyed after we eat next time though?
Oh, hang on.
Because we got it today.
We got it today.
Yeah, we literally just got it today, so it would stay for one full month and then
is... Oh, God. I'm going to fucking look this up. Okay.
Oops, sorry.
Flush everything from future resources into the space as available resources.
Yeah, we just put them into the available. So.
Yeah, you eat first and then you discard after you eat.
Yeah, so...
Okay, so we're going to discard one anyway.
Eat is action one, so we'd eat that food, and then action four on the night is to discard.
Yeah, so...
I then just take a heart to be at max?
Sure.
So we... Because then it's going away anyway, right?
No, it's not. It's not. That's the thing.
Oh.
No, it does go away because we discard it.
Yeah, we've already eaten, Doc.
We've already eaten. I took four out earlier.
Oh, okay. So yeah, okay. Sorry, I thought they stayed in storage for a month.
No, they don't. They literally
is just tonight.
The only one that stays.
So you may,
is the
may as well take the health.
Okay, let's get the cellar next, guys.
Actually, I think the raft might be pretty fucking good.
We haven't got the rope here.
So we need to really focus on wood because now we have stuff coming in, weather. So
bots.
Well, production phase, I can get one.
Right.
Which is nice.
So,
night phase. Don't we get one wood and one food? Oh no, in the morning.
In the morning, we do.
Yeah. Oh, the cellar makes all of our food
non-perishable.
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's I thought it just like converted one. So no. Yeah, that's really fucking good.
It's really good. Yeah. Okay. So,
I have a question.
Yes.
Like, if we've already got the fire, do we need this at all, or?
Yes. We have the fireplace, but we don't actually have the fire technology.
Fire. Okay, right.
All right, so...
we're lighting all our cigarettes off this one campfire.
Okay, Sheepdog, you're up, mate. What are you doing?
Oh, no, yeah, no, that worked. I'm up?
Yes, it's your turn. You're first player this turn, so...
Oh, okay, fun.
Wait, hang on. We do... This falls off, so... Yeah. Okay, so we got to fight this now. I don't, like... I guess we just have to assign someone to this.
I have most health. And
fight the beast. How do we normally do it when we get attacked by something? Is it first player that does it, or do we choose who goes?
So the dog's going to go out.
Does that give us an attack?
And fight the beast. Wait, does that mean... Hang on, does that mean...
We're only going to take one damage, right?
No. We're only going to take one damage. So here's what I think happens, though. No, we're going to take two damage because it's we don't have enough.
We've got one fight.
Yes, but for every it does two damage, and for every damage that we can't replace with weapon, like this will go to zero, right? It'll
no, because we got the knife that doesn't drop below one. Now.
Yes, but it still does two damage to us, so we only got one. So the person who's going to be the leader is going to take two damage off this thing.
I thought you said that the fight we have,
yes,
takes off one of their fight.
Yes, it does. So see the skull, we have currently one damage.
Which one? The black skull.
Yes, the black damage is how much damage it does to us. Next is the skull with the sticks behind it. That's how much damage it does to our weapon. If our weapon is one and it takes two off, with the remainder right of the weapon damage gets put to damage onto the player.
No, we fight first and then the weapon gets damaged after.
Yes, it does, yes.
Yeah.
But because we have the knife, it doesn't go under one.
We're always at one, so yeah. Yeah. So it's going to hit us for one damage and our knife will stay at one.
But then because it's a negative two, we still take one of that as
HP damage. Yeah, we take an additional damage.
Yes. So you'll be taking... Whoever fights this thing is going to take two damage, essentially.
I'm just trying to find the rules on when things attack us.
Do we lose a meeple to fight this?
That's what we're trying to work out, whether or not we lose a meeple to this action. So, but this does go off. So, put that over there. This moves down. This goes there.
La 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 la. How are you guys finding the
well, this vibe? This is during the event phase. It literally says that, so...
It's a bit...
Deserted. Oh, wait, no. See how it says the expedition phase there? So it probably happens during the action phase. So we're going to have to... Like, this thing has to be fought, essentially.
Well, it says and fight the beast.
Yes. So. And fight the beast, yes. So we
so
have...
So this to... has gone... So is this it... being resolved right now?
Yeah, yes, but see how it has the phase there? During the expedition?
There are so many icons. I see. So
Oh, no, wait. No, right. No. It happens right now because this is the bottom phase.
Yeah,
is...
when it gets pushed off is when it activates.
Yeah. Okay, so I don't think we can use it.
I'm checking Board Game Geek to see what they say about it because I think it attacks the camp.
That's what I was assuming.
I can take the three damage because I'm max.
It'd be two damage, not three.
Two damage, sorry.
Yeah,
and that won't affect me too badly.
Yeah, this game is called Robinson Crusoe. It's basically a Tom Hanks game.
It's every survival crafting game on Steam, but a board game. Yeah. So therefore, better.
So I'm just going to assume that it's going to take a meeple to do
the
this.
First player fights it.
Oh, okay. So that's
if the beast is laying the first player resolves the fight as if they had hunted it. So it does not cost you meeples. You just resolve it as if you had hunted it. Basically, it attacked you in camp.
So okay, so I take two damage.
Yes.
And
we get two food.
We get two food. Yes, we get two food. And you get a
discovery.
Discovery, yeah.
What you get? What was it eating? What was it in its stomach?
Was a treasure. So you
treasure chest. You probably saw that. Because it's a snake.
Hey,
right?
Treasure map. Okay.
Ooh, treasure map. Nice.
Keep this card. You can use it once. Take an exploration action. On this card, draw two mystery cards and resolve two. Discard after use. Okay, so...
Only resolve two treasures. So
wait, that's really good. That's a treasure that turns itself into a free explore and two free treasures.
No, I think what...
No, like, you use it as
When you're exploring.
Yeah, so he explores and he's going to get two free treasures when he does the explore, whether there's a treasure there or not.
So
no, you don't actually explore the a place. You just
take an exploration treasure on this card. Sorry, yes, you're right.
What happened to the other animals that we killed? Where'd the gorilla go?
I put it up here.
Oh, okay, yeah, cool. All right, so now we do this. Go. Nope, not yet.
No.
During the production phase this round, you get no wood. Does that question mark mean that we have to pull one of these out?
Yep, green. No, green question mark goes up on here.
Yeah, goes on green.
Okay.
So that means we can't get wood from any...
Yes.
Of the things we're
during the production
phase. Like this.
So the free wood stuff, yeah.
Okay, everyone gets 2 morale now.
Can I just spend 2 morale to get my diary?
Yeah, I guess so.
Once the thing starts, yes.
Yeah. Wait, can I spend 2 morale before the thing starts?
Nope.
No.
Okay. It's only during your phase, so.
All right.
Okay, so you spend 2, great, and now you can move your dudes around. Maybe do an explore. I don't know. Take a dog for an explore.
I'm gonna explore, Sheepy.
I think let the explorer explore.
Yeah.
Can
reroll greens.
He's going to have to take an event the next time he explores.
I mean, I can cancel it if we want.
Yeah, but I can reroll green dice anyway. So
yeah.
So he could get the thing and. It could, like, not
does
be
the
terrible.
Treasure map work like as a group? I think it does. You
don't
have to.
I don't know. All I was gonna say is, like, why don't I just use the dog to explore this?
No. It's a helper. You have to still help it.
Oh, poopy bop.
It can't do its own thing.
Okay. So
get the treasure, Sheepy, and then try and get some.
Yeah, I'll get the treasure.
A thing.
Okay. So I will also.
Do you want to try and get that?
You will still have to roll for this, by the way.
Yeah.
So you could take the dog with you. It says take an exploration action on this card, so you would still have to roll for it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So maybe take the dog with you there.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay, so we don't actually get... So what are you doing? What do you want to do? I think honestly we should get some wood because we need to actually
The cellar.
I don't really have any useful rerolls or anything, so maybe I should build. Wait, no, you have rerolls on building, right? Or something?
Yeah, the carpenter does.
Yeah, I can reroll on building. So
all right, I'll just gather some wood then because we're gonna need wood.
Yep, we're gonna need wood.
There you go.
Cool. Oh, you can get an extra... Oh, you can spend less wood if you spend 2 things. That's pretty good.
Oh, wait. So, hang on. Dude, we didn't get... We didn't do the production phase, did we?
We still get the food, don't we? We still get 2 food for the production.
No, yeah, we get 3 food, actually.
3 food?
1, 2, 3.
The shortcut. Or it's whatever he chooses to take, so I'm assuming...
Well, we can't take wood,
right?
We can't take wood.
Yeah.
So,
well, we can't
get some food.
Yeah.
So, 3 food. Okay, alright.
Hey guys, we're all going to actually eat tonight. Things are looking up.
Yay!
Peachy,
2 nights in a row. Well, 2 months in a row.
Okay, so...
These parrots are tasty.
Explore, bro.
Do we need scouting? No, I'm just going to explore then.
You can explore, like, in 2 tiles, by the way.
Yeah, I might just do 2 tiles. Kind of. Okay. Well, let's get this, because then I can move the shortcut around. Actually, I think I'm going to explore up here.
No, you can't move the shortcut around, by the way.
Yeah. The shortcut's you spent it. To...
You spent it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You've discovered a shortcut to this place.
Yep.
So, I see.
So it's,
okay.
It's up, yeah.
Okay.
All right, you're up, Doc. What are you doing?
BRB.
I kind of want the cellar.
The cellar and the raft would be great. I'm just pointing that out there right now. We don't have enough wood for the raft, so I go for the cellar.
Yeah, I'm gonna go for the cellar.
And maybe we should
the rope. We haven't built the rope yet.
Yeah.
Oh, did we fail the rope? Rope would be nice. So would the sack, to be honest.
I can get the sack on my turn. So
yeah.
I'll do the sack.
Yeah, you haven't gone yet, have you? So you're going to go for the sack?
I'll go for the sack. And I think I'll also go for the fence too. So
there's two pieces of wood left if we want.
I was gonna say I might gather some wood because we are getting. No, we really haven't done much towards our objective.
Nope, we're gonna lose if we don't do that. So. Wait, doesn't the hatchet? Oh, the hatchet.
We do still have our hammer and nails. Let's not forget these things.
And the flask of rum, yeah.
Yeah. Actually, how does a hammer and nails work?
You just use it and you get
Oh, you
a
just use it, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You don't actually have to put a guy there. Okay. No. I might...
So here's what I'm thinking, right? I'm going to put one on the sack and one on the furnace. I'm going to spend three and I'm going to use one of these things and we can just auto-complete both of these things.
Right.
Okay.
I forgot to do my reconnaissance as well on my turn.
Wait, can you do that for
I'm
going to
just gather some wood.
Okay, cool. And... So I'm going to spend three of my duders. I'm going
you can still
to...
do that now, can't you?
I think I can only use these on my turn.
Yeah.
Okay.
Shit. Can we retcon?
Oh, I mean, we're currently playing, so probably not. There we go.
But I mean, it doesn't interfere in the order of play.
What does it do? What does it do?
It just means I can look at... three tiles for exploring and place the one I want up top.
Sure, whatever. I don't care.
Are they land tiles?
It's land tiles, yeah.
One, two, three. Okay.
So here's what you do. Put the two back in there, then reshuffle it, and then put the one you want on top.
Which would probably be the river, most likely.
Yeah, we need the river, don't we?
Yeah, we don't have a river yet.
Okay. So yeah.
And you'll get three mystery things.
Alright, and then shuffle that shit and then put that back in there. Okay, so, yep.
Uh-oh.
Now we activate the stuff. And Sheepdog, you go first. So, you're doing your treasure map?
Yeah. So, I don't roll, but I do take a card.
Take an extra card. Yep.
Shrine, discard this card or draw one mystery card.
You get three mystery cards of this shit. Oh my god.
And shuffle this. Okay, so nightmares. Put on the building, gathering resources. During the next action, you have to have.
So, what that means is one of these tokens will go here.
Yeah.
And, no, you'd put one on each one.
Yeah.
And any success we have.
You have to re-roll.
You have to re-roll the success.
I don't think that's a problem. The odds
are pretty
good.
No, I'm going to discard that.
Yeah.
What was the... I guess.
Hang on. How long do they stay?
Until you use them, so...
Yeah. So they're... When this
when they're put on top of the deck, they stay there until someone uses them.
Yeah, but Henley's got a re-roll for building. Doc's got a re-roll on his thing. I can re-roll greens. I don't think it's that much of an issue.
So...
Treasures. Nothing, only treasures.
Nothing. Okay, you get cave with furs.
Yay.
And whatever that is.
An amulet.
A portrait of a beautiful lady.
Oh, Sheepy's got a wank bank.
Yeah, dude. So, cover two on character cards.
Ooh, furs. Nice.
To indicate that they are not resolved. Mm. What one?
Cover.
Oh.
Okay.
Is anyone below? Because that would actually.
I've gone below, but that's already happened. So I can.
Oh, so we can ignore someone's morale hit.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm gonna put that on.
I would say me and probably Henley, because we're the closest to actually losing one. Like Peachy's got a. Big way to go before he loses one.
Yeah.
You've got fucking forever to go.
Well,
but actually, you've already lost your one.
I've already done
mine. Yeah, but yours is all the way at the end there. All right, that's
yeah.
Seems
well, that's good. That's actually you gain a morale when you come back from it, I believe.
No, you don't.
It's facing the other way.
Actually, that will mean that mine's that there because it's been done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it doesn't happen again. And we get two furs.
Nice.
It goes in the top one. All right.
You're welcome, bitches.
All right.
So now you resolve. So you got a first roll.
One sec.
This thing here. Go ahead, Peachy. Oh wait, no. He needs to. No. Hang on. We need to do the gray. For sheepdog. Oh, we can do that when he comes back, I guess. So, go ahead, roll. Okay, so you get a question mark.
What did you find?
Here.
Okay, so decide. Discard this card or build one item. Knife, rope, shovel, rope. Or cure for free building without rope. An action.
I'm building rope.
All night long you had nightmares rope. About the dead resident and the ruined hut. You lose a morale and you draw another card. That's not actually too bad of a hit.
Okay. Yeah, I don't think that's too bad. We've got ways to put up our inspiration. So you
and it's, yeah, and just it's free rope.
Okay.
Does this instantly happen or?
Yeah. No, okay. It goes up there.
It goes up there.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, Sheepdog, you have to roll your gray ones, mate.
Oh, God.
That sounded dirty. Sheep, you got to roll your gray ones, amulet.
Viper, shuffle the event deck. Viper hides in your clothes. Okay, shuffle into the event deck. Okay. So
at some point, a viper that's in my clothes I don't know about is going to bite me?
Awesome. Yep.
Make sure we're only pressing 5 on these... on the shuffle.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing, yeah.
What was the gray for?
Because you fucking went for wood, mate.
Oh, yeah, hell yeah, I did.
Got wood.
So
got
put wood, that wood up there. Okay.
Okay, let's grab another land tile.
No. You got to roll first, mate.
Oh, right, to see if I actually succeed.
It might be a failure.
Okay, you're good. Pull that bag out.
What did you find? It's a tiger.
Is it possibly
it's
a tiger?
In your clothes.
Discard this card and execute night phase outside the camp. And execute the night phase outside the camp. What? Execute the night phase outside the camp or shuffle into the event deck.
We just fight this, right?
Wait, execute the night phase outside of the camp.
Yeah, I don't know.
So does that mean you don't get things outside of the camp? You have to stay outside the camp this turn?
Oh, so he doesn't get to eat. He doesn't get to do any of the night phase things. Yeah, he's okay. Hiding from the tiger in the woods. Or he can shuffle it in and fight the tiger.
This tiger isn't that crazy.
Are you kidding me? You take 2 HP right now, or we spend forever building weapons to fight it.
No, I think it'd fight him now. Oh, no, it's shuffled into the event deck. I mean, it gives us 2 food and 1 hide, right? It's got 4 damage. It'll break our tool by 1, and it'll damage our palisade. That's a really
It can't break our tool.
If we do build a tool, it can be broken.
So are you putting that in the event phase, or are you going to stay outside?
No, if it's just easier for me to take... How much do I take?
No, you don't take it now. You
two, because I can't eat.
Yeah.
But you also won't be able to do any other night phase activities.
Yep.
Which,
as you might want to do.
You can't masturbate.
Okay.
Basically, that's what I was getting at.
But you succeeded.
You can masturbate
so
in the wood. You... The tiger might smell you.
Smell you? Jesus.
All right. So don't forget you get your, you get 3 of these discovery tokens.
And 4, then... right?
Oh, no, you get
4. Holy shit.
And
it's all going to be tigers.
We get two beasts. Ooh. That go into the deck.
I've got a meeple.
You get a shield.
So we get a +1 palisade.
Yeah, that's good.
Nice.
You can 1 weapon into a hide or a food.
No, I don't think that's worth doing.
Is that conversion or is that...
That's conversion.
If we have one.
That's conversion.
Well, we don't technically have a weapon to spend, so... Yeah.
Technically...
Well, we can't lose one, so we can just...
No, we can't...
That's why we've bought... made the knife, right?
Yeah, but that means we don't have one to spend to gain that. Yeah. So that can't happen.
It swaps, mate. Well,
I don't know, like...
I don't think that's right, because we've gone into making the knife.
I mean...
I think this
is why we've made a knife to do this.
Yeah, we've made the knife for combat purposes. This isn't really combat purposes. I don't know if...
Well, I mean, we're getting...
Look, all you need to know is that if we take it, it goes to 0, right?
No,
and we can't.
We
go
can't
to... Yes, but we don't... What I'm saying is it doesn't convert. Like, there's no conversion.
Yeah, what I'm saying is because we've got the knife, we've always got one to spare.
Yeah, that it kind of makes, like, you know, just coming across something which you skin and you know, get the food off.
Yeah, that's
that's how I'd interpret it, you know, kind of.
I wouldn't interpret it that way, but okay. I think it's 2-for-2 right now. I say we flip a fucking coin.
Well, just read the rules.
I'm assuming Doc's on Board Game Geek's going, like...
Yeah, probably. We get wood as well. Did anyone take the wood over?
No.
Do we have anything here that counts as a coin token, or are all these non-coin tokens? So these are just chips, so they don't actually random flip.
I mean, I'm happy to say that it doesn't count as anything, but...
I feel like it shouldn't, because it consumes a knife to produce a resource.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. It consumes...
Yeah, but that makes no sense, that it would consume a knife. Maybe it would consume...
It makes no sense that having a sword and killing a bird breaks your sword. I mean...
Yeah, no. Have you played Breath of the Wild or The Witcher 3? My sword's broken.
All right, heads, it's whatever, tails...
I'm good.
Alright, heads. So, it's whatever.
That fucking solved nothing.
What does whatever mean?
Alright, so...
What does whatever mean?
Heads means that it doesn't... It converts, but we can't spend because we've got it. And tails mean that we can because we have infinite ones. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay,
so it doesn't convert. Good?
Sure.
All right, good. Sure. Happy as Larry.
And we gain a wood.
We've already done the wood. Yeah. But the wood goes up here. So.
So now I will... I'll do my explore. I have my resource gather.
Mm-hmm. Roll that shit.
Nice.
So we just get a wood.
Nailed it.
Perfect. And now you can build.
And now I will construct.
No, not good. But you get a brown.
I'm gonna re-roll my success dice.
Okay, good.
Nice. Got it. And I do still get the event, and I put in some laborious work. Put -1 on the building action field. Ooh. Okay, so this means when you go to build something, it's going to cost you an extra dude, basically.
Thanks.
It's very hard work. Takes a lot of time.
Okay.
What we got left that we want to build, though? The raft?
Okay, so my turn. I just do it because I'm perfect. I don't have to roll shit. So we both get the sack and the furnace.
Didn't that use one of the hammer?
Yes, it did. It used one of those, yes.
Would that activate this, or is that the next time someone goes to it?
What do you mean? No, it's when the next time someone goes to it.
Okay.
So whatever we build next is what.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure actually this goes on every single one of these things, but I could be wrong.
Yeah, it's whenever you go to build something next, it costs you an extra dude.
Yep. All right. So that's...
So one dude counts as zero, two dudes counts as one. You'd need three dudes for a guaranteed success.
Oh.
I do have a meeple.
What? What are you talking
about? Isn't this for when you do an event?
No, when you do a brown.
No, it's for the next time you go to do a construction.
In order.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
So you didn't automatically succeed. All right. To roll.
So now.
So if you do it on the first one.
No. It's the next time someone. No. It's the next time someone goes to do a construction task. It activates.
Yeah.
Okay. So now.
Because he's already on the building action field. So yeah.
And
we get all our cool shit. All
right. So first things first. We do. Yep. All that goes down. Now we roll a weather die. Because this is the first time we've had to do this. We only roll the white one. No, the yellow one. Let me roll the yellow one. Okay.
Just leave the food there for a sec, because we'll be throwing it back up in a second. Anyway.
Okay.
It's a rain.
So, with rain... We have a roof.
We have a roof.
Now, I just want to double check if we lose that roof. I hope we don't, because that would suck.
Amount of freaking wood we spent on it. I hope not.
Yeah, but we would lose all that food if we didn't. So, and then everyone would take 2 HP.
Rave dangerous.
That's what I'm saying. It just washes everything away. That's why you
rave
need
is what?
Rain is dangerous.
Like losing 2 health because it's raining? Fuck me.
Okay.
I was doing a simple joke and you ruined my life.
Winter clouds.
No, we don't have winter clouds, so. What is for winter clouds?
Rainy. Storm tokens. I think it's only storm tokens that destroy buildings, not rain clouds. Rain clouds destroy food.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Resolve rain. Compare roof levels to each cloud that goes through. Discard 1 food and 1 wood. In this case, 4 clouds equals minus 1 roof equals 3. So we don't need to do anything because we only had 1 cloud, so...
Yeah, one rain, 1 roof. They cancel each other out. Nothing happens.
Yep.
Yeah.
For now.
So when does it actually get damaged, though? Damage in weather phase affects all players. Okay, yep. I don't know, when does the roof go down?
Storm tokens destroy the palisade.
So what's a storm token?
There are more clouds than your current roof level. Discard 1 food and 1 wood for each cloud.
Wait, you lose.
I don't think it does unless there's like events that destroy.
There's
roof.
Probably events.
Okay, great, perfect, yeah. perfect. Okay. And now we do night phase, and 4 people eat. So 1, 2, 3.
No.
3 people eat. Peachy is not there.
Peachy's not there.
So Peachy,
wait, where's Peachy?
You take. He got left out because of the.
I'm exploring.
So you take 2
who's
HP.
Who's Peachy?
Yep. And oh, by the way, the cellar. No wait, what costs?
Yeah, we have the cellar.
What
so
costs it's... the sack? Okay, this costs a thing, so I have to put that in the bin.
Yeah.
Okay, we have 4 wood and 2 bananas, so does anyone want to heal? We can heal the missionary once.
Well, sheep, you can actually heal up to here.
Oh, wait, hang on. Do you want to? We've got heal. The cellar now, so we can just make that.
Yeah, we can make them non-perishable. Yeah.
Yeah, don't heal Sheepy because he's still got this, so that doesn't count for a morale loss.
Oh, he's already used it, so.
Yeah, he's already activated that, so he's got to get all the way down here.
So I'm gonna change,
and he could do with losing a few pounds anyway.
I'm gonna make these into non-perishable then. Cool.
We turn bananas into bread.
Banana bread.
Banana bread.
Just like Jesus.
But no, it's just banana shaped like all right, a bread loaf.
Peachy,
banana
you're up.
All right, I'm first.
First things first. Hang on. Each player discards 1 inspiration if you have them.
Ooh. Okay.
Well.
If you do not have inspiration, you'll take a damage.
Yep. Alright, that moves down. This comes over. Flip this shit. Alright, landslide. Move your camp to an adjacent tile of your choice. Securing the camp. Discard. Okay, so I'm pretty sure we lose a palisade level and a roof level by moving.
Yeah, I would imagine that.
You lose half rounded up, I think.
Move
it is.
Camp. So when you move camp, your roof and palisade levels are halved rounding up. So we don't, because we're both level 1. So, but if it was level 2, it would go down to 1 sort of thing.
So should we just move it to here?
No, I don't think so. I think where we should move it is to another, is to, there's no food. So here's the thing. We have a shortcut over there, so we can get a food.
Maybe...
No, but we can't
maybe
get
move
a,
it here.
We can't use that. Then
that's got no wood.
It's got no wood, well, yeah. And we can't. No, we'll,
but when we can't, when we bring no, this over, it'll that, bring a
yeah,
wood
this
with
place
it.
Is, this place is no different to this.
Okay, like hang on, this, hang yeah. on. So we can't take advantage of the shortcut anymore if we do that, though.
Why not?
Because it has to be next to the camp.
No, it only needs to be next to it to place it. During the production phase, you get 1 resource available from the tile with the shortcut
yeah.
on it. It,
yeah, so
it has to be there. Adjacent to it to place it, but.
So maybe
the
we
only problem
go
with
here,
that,
then.
Yeah, actually, the problem with this is we'd lose our free house. If we move up here, we get to keep the free house.
True.
Okay, yeah, go to the free house.
Free house.
It's free.
It is nice not having to worry about sleeping outside and losing HP.
Yeah, okay, cool. We can move back there anyway, so next turn. Peachy, you're up, mate.
Okay, shall I just keep exploring or shall I fight?
I mean, I think we should fight. We've got a cellar now, so any food we get is just fucking golden.
Okay, so does anyone want the dog?
No, if you're fighting, I think you should take the dog with you.
No. Okay.
So you what so, you yeah. Yep. Okay.
And I think I've got
a brown meeple that you can use to get something.
I could get a free explore. Or a free something. What do we do? How are we doing for like wood and stuff? Because we haven't moved this track at all.
Oh, we should have.
We've kind of been preparing base camp, and now we're kind of in a good position to start harvesting tons of wood and stacking it up. Like, we've got the sack, so we'll be able to get 2 wood per resource action instead of 1.
Yeah.
Okay. So
that's for one person, we'll be able to get like a second wood when you do a research action.
So I'm gonna go.
Hang on. Before we do that, where'd we get this bananas from? Is that from stockpile stuff?
Yeah.
Okay, so we moved, right? We get 2 wood. We get 1 banana, and we can take a food or a wood from over here.
I suggest we take wood.
I suggest we take food because I'm gonna get wood.
We have 2 food.
So where did this extra banana come from?
That was from before we moved. Yeah. So yeah, put that back and replace it with an extra wood because this one.
Yeah. So we got 2 wood, 1 banana. Now what are we getting? A food or a banana?
I suggest a wood.
Well, if we get a food, then we don't have to get wood. We don't have to get food this turn. But you are
someone's hunting.
Yeah. So maybe we
you don't lose a fight. Even if it like hits you for 72 damage, you still kill it.
Yeah. Okay. So that's,
get stockpile wood then, and I'll collect wood on this one, and I'll use my other meeple to get more wood.
No, that's building, mate.
That's a buildy.
Oh.
So you could do.
The oh, field. Okay.
So
what
I
would build.
So what I would suggest doing then is maybe getting the raft. We've got rope. So if you want to do that, I can jump onto the raft.
Because then you can automatically pass that, can't you?
Yes, I can.
Yeah. Now with that extra one.
Uh-huh.
Okay, cool. Let me just check. I think I need to save my inspiration for a green action die. What do you roll for a hunt?
The green
Nothing.
Die.
Nothing.
Then...
Greens explore.
Yeah, greens explore. Okay.
That's... Scouting, no. Oh, yeah. I'm going to discard 3 and draw 2 of those things, whatever they're called, treasure things.
Oh, we didn't get our inspiration for the turn, by the way, guys, so everyone gets 2 of those.
Oh, yeah, shit.
I get 3.
Oh, no, everyone gets 3, by the way.
Wait, no.
Yeah, it's a group thing. Plus 1. Everyone gets...
I get to discard one of these.
So everyone gets a 3rd one because of the diary, so...
Yeah, remember, normally that would be over here and we'd have to build it, but you started with it as a free item, basically.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So you got a pot to plus food, plus health.
Do we have a pot?
I mean, no.
Oh, hang on. We've got rivers now, so we can literally... We don't need these anymore. We can literally build everything now. Oops, sorry.
Yeah.
I don't think we need to build the pot, or does that stack with my fireplace ability?
No, I don't think it does.
Because it's... Yeah, it's literally the same thing, except the fireplace is better.
Yeah, fireplace is
except...
better.
Except... Wait. You get 2, that gets 1. So what's this no-entry sign?
The no-entry sign is a medallion of the lady. You get 3 extra...
Inspiration.
Okay, so I'll put this one back in here.
I think that's pretty neat of them to do that. They do these with symbols on them, and the scenario dictates what they do.
Yeah, it was discard one.
So you're keeping that? So you get 3 inspiration then.
Okay. Is there anything else I want to spend inspiration on then in that case? I can put our inspiration up to heal or get inspiration.
Sure.
It probably doesn't hurt just to have it up.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's do that then.
Okay. Done. Doc, you're up, mate. What are you doing?
Right, I think we need wood. I think we need quite a lot of wood.
Yes, I agree.
So I'm going to do some wood gathering.
So keep in mind that we will need to put 2 wood into the thing. Before we build,
and I think on the next one we should build the mast. It costs us one wood and gives us three in here, so that will just complete that.
Yep, I get.
But it costs us one wood and a hide, but we have the rope, so it's okay. Mm-hmm, and yeah. So I'm going to gather wood there, and I guess I'll just gather more wood. I can't see anything that we really need.
Yeah, just gather another wood. Yep.
How are we doing for food?
Yeah, we've got enough food. Oh, no, we're missing. Yeah, you're going to fight something, so we're going to get enough food. All right,
I could make stone soup and give us a food, but I don't think we really need it.
No, I don't think we need it. So I'm going
stone
to...
Stone soup!
Yeah.
Why don't you put one on this thing?
Yeah, no, that's what I was going to do. So I've got one on here...
So and that'll use up this, right?
Yes, it would, yes.
And then you can, like, maybe build a fire or the map?
We do still have hammer and nails as well.
So what I'm thinking...
Or you can auto... auto succeed on the raft. Oh, you can reroll anyway.
Yeah, I can reroll. It's fine. What I'm going to do is I'm going to... I think we're going to take the shield.
Or, maybe increase this.
Yeah.
I think we've only got a really low chance of having a bad, like really bad weather.
Yeah, but if we have really bad rope weather.
So here's what I'm thinking. Like, okay, we can't take anything that's going to cost. Because this is going to cost two wood to build this, right?
We've also got to remember about this.
Yes, fire. Yes, we're working on it. Don't worry about it. So okay. at the end of your turn, we're going to put two wood in there. It's going to cost two wood to build the raft, and that's all the wood that we can use. So we can't build anything that requires wood. We can build the fire, which would give us an extra palisade level.
The map, which would give us extra exploration.
I don't think
exploration doesn't seem that important.
I don't think we need that right now. I think either a shield would be good, it needs the wood. So I'm thinking a fire would be great. I don't think we're going to move anymore, by the way. So
yeah, explore. I don't think we need to explore.
So I'm just going
to
go there.
Well, we can reach everywhere from here, so this is a good place to be, really.
Actually, before I do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to spend 3, and I'm going to draw 5 invention cards from the deck and choose one of them. So,
okay.
So have you got enough for a reroll, Hanley, if you do that?
Nope. It's fine, though. So, 1.
Wait, are these all the inventions we're allowed?
4.
No, these cards don't normally go here. We just put them here out of convenience. There is
okay, one, so like, more slots. We can get a spear. We can get a bow. We can get a bed. What's a bed do? What's that icon? Oh, it just gives you something to rest on?
That's a rest. It's a rest icon.
So, that would just replace
a rest gives you an inspiration like and an extra health. Yeah.
That's not
so. A spear, though, means that we can always get food.
Coral. Cover any parrot map on the tile against into your camp with a black and put one. Okay. Shit, that's fucking awesome. The corral is great. I might pick that.
But this here will give us a constant +3.
Maybe.
I don't think these are constant. I feel like it's... You might lose it.
No, it's the item, isn't it? Because you change the knife and some wood into a spear.
No, see how on the knife, how it has a knife there permanently?
Yeah.
Do you see that? But so on the spear and the bow, it doesn't have it. Do you see that? So that means that we don't have that anymore. Also, I honestly think that that's the case, because if you look at the knife, you get +1 and then it just disappears, but you need the knife to build other stuff. So that's what I think that means. I don't think it means that we get a permanent sword. So what I'm thinking, we can also...
I feel like it puts us on 3, but we don't have the knife anymore.
Yeah, so here's what I'm thinking.
No, you keep these always. You don't discard these.
You don't discard them, So here's what
this would give us 4.
Yeah, but it would
four.
Yeah, but it would disappear when it gets damaged, right? It's the spear doesn't... It's a once-use item.
Okay.
So here's what I'm thinking. We either take belt or we take the corral.
But if you look at something like the pistol here, it says temporarily. This doesn't say temporarily.
The pistol is a starter item, so it only gets two uses, same as like the flask of rum and the hammer of nails. After those two uses are gone, it's gone forever. Yep. You've only got two bullets, basically.
Okay. So, wait, the drum... Oh, you get a plus two during morale phase. That's actually not bad.
That's pretty good, because we've been keeping our morale up, so we've been getting a lot of inspiration. If we get enough inspiration where we can start spending them really rapidly, we can probably progress really well.
I like the idea of the bed, to be honest.
So I'm going to go for the belt.
All right, make a choice.
We're going for the belt.
Okay.
I'll put the dog down there.
So how do we get these other ones?
I have to...
Henley can do it. Yeah, that's basically it.
It's already, okay. Yeah, just making sure.
He can spend inspiration.
Actually, no, we couldn't get the belt. We couldn't get the belt because it was five out. So it was these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the sling was back there. So, yeah.
Sorry.
All right, so yeah, it's the wall, the corral, the bed, the spear, or the bow.
I said beds.
I'm like
that wall is really cheap for two palisade levels. Just saying, that's 8 wood for.
Yeah.
For, like, that's pretty good.
The corral is pretty good too because we get extra food every turn just by default.
Yeah.
So what are we at now? Like, that would put us at 2 food, maybe 3 food a turn. Then we'd only have to find 1 food. Every turn.
That's actually not terrible. And we do have the cellar, so we can... It's not never going to go to waste if we get
extra
food.
I'm going to get this. We're taking this. That's what's happening.
Yeah. The less we have to worry about food, the more wood we can gather.
Yep. I agree. Okay. So, for my second act, I'm going to go here. And I'm going to use the final hammer and nails, and I'm going to put a dodo on it.
Cool.
So I do have to roll one for the other thing, but
the first one. Yep. Yeah.
But missionary, you're up. Your turn. Yep.
Wait, don't you put a thing on the parrot?
When it's built.
And.
But that also means that every other time, like,
It'll be on the camp, okay, so we're gaining an extra food every time.
It's adjacent. So, yeah. So if you do your scouting, find a parrot one and then put it here.
He's gonna go after you. So,
but what I'm saying is, I can change that.
I do have three.
Yeah. So you can do that now. We can save that till next turn, and then we can get two parrots instead of one. And this turn I can get the fire, and that'll just give us a...
So I'm doing this now?
Yeah. Yep. So, yeah, search for a parrot from the top three. Wrong one, dude. Wrong one. You're scouting.
It's the brown bag.
No.
Dude, yes. Reconnaissance.
You said scouting.
Reconnaissance.
Whatever.
Reconnaissance. So I only discard two. Two, three.
We got a parrot. That's cool.
A parrot.
With wood as well.
Which is the best one?
Oh, we don't want the
volcano.
Volcano.
Well, they're both the same, except for the... Yeah, they're both the same. So, no caves, though. So, yeah, just get...
But, do you want to walk the mountains, or do you want to go through the jungle?
Jungle is massive.
Yeah, jungle is massive.
Wait, hang on. Hang on, there's... What does that do then? Is that just
a volcano?
No, it's just a blocker.
Yeah,
you can't get fuck all in the in the old thing.
It's just a huge fuck you.
It's a big old fuck off.
Big old fuck you.
All right, good. So I'm not gonna go there this turn, and I'm not gonna spend this. I'll just put that there. So that'll be my turn. All right. Sorry, sheepdog. That's it.
What? Who? What? Where? Huh?
Okay. Good. Where? Perfect. Okay,
now we
good.
Move to next phase.
Next phase. Hang on. We put two.
Wood. I like this game. This is fun.
We put two wood up here. Yep. That's good. Everyone's agreeing?
Yep. We put two wood in there.
Okay.
We are progressing with the game, guys. We're going to win.
Maybe. All right, 2 wood. Now, now we roll. Peachy, you're up first.
Okay, no, so I'm gonna fight.
Wait, yes, you are. Yeah.
Well, let's just get.
No.
Let's fight first. I want to fight first.
Okay, we'll flip the first one.
Flip that shit,
Fox. Okay, yeah. Cool. So you take 1 damage.
No, he doesn't, because we have a helmet, so he could ignore 1.
Yeah,
wound.
That's true. Yep. So
sweet.
So you just murdered a
that
fox with your head.
That food is terrible. But
I don't know.
Okay.
It's good, and we get
have
a skin.
Have you ever eaten fox before?
Yes, I have.
Why?
Because there's foxes everywhere.
Because it's meat. It's meat. Like.
Okay.
Why would you waste it?
Wait, I'm sorry.
Why would you eat meat?
Did you just say you ate it because there are foxes everywhere?
In Australia, yes. And we killed one, so we ate it. What's wrong with
that? What's
wrong
mate?
With Australia? It's like, oh, it's there, so I may as well fucking eat it.
Why would you kill it and not eat it? That makes no sense.
All right, roll the gray ones.
Roll the gray ones first. Yeah, my bad.
And presumably, if you're eating something, you're going to kill it first. This isn't an egg.
Are you absolute bastard?
All right. You flipping?
Yep.
Okay, discard this card or get 2 things. So here's the thing, right?
Do we need 2 furs?
We can. The furs can be very useful to building things. So we can, instead of using wood to upgrade our roof, we can use furs.
That negative isn't terrible, actually, because it's only 1 less food, not no food. It's just one less food.
Okay.
I'd say take the furs.
We're taking the chance. We're risking 1 food. Later for 2 furs now. I think that's pretty okay.
Yeah. So, I will glad to pay you Thursday for a fur today.
Okay, well, whatever's coming up next is going to be that. So, okay. Sheep Doc, you're up, mate.
Did you put the wood on?
I did, yes.
Cool.
He did. Okay, so I'm gathering 2x for wood. Cool. So let's roll the first one.
Damage.
Take a wound, but we get a wood.
I'll put the wood up. Roll you. Again.
Don't you get 2 wood? Second one. Sack.
Yeah. Actually, we should make sure one of us actually uses that. So yes, I'll use the sack and gather a second wood.
Okay. So now you get a 3rd wood, and
get a wound as well.
And shuffle into the event deck. Storm. Put. Oh God. See.
We should have got another fur then.
No. It's only once. It's only once. It's only once. Okay, so this is how we lose. This is how we damage things. Okay.
So we put a weather token in there when it shows up. So that's in the future.
Okay.
At least that got rid of whatever this was.
All right, my turn.
It would have been the headache.
Yeah, probably. I'm going to.
Well, maybe not. There's 2 of those in there now.
Yeah, I'm going to do the raft first. So this we have to roll because we're not at perfect. So. Okay, good. I take a damage, and we pop one of these bad boys. Fast work. Discard this card, or take 1 more building action. Must roll all 3 die and shuffle into the main deck.
I'm not sure that's worth.
I don't know if that's worth it. What else could we build? There'd be nothing else. There's nothing worth else building.
You have
wood, or take. Hang on. Or take 1 more build action. Must roll all 3.
Corral's pretty good though.
No, we want to get the extra parrot before we do that though.
Would that mean you could do the mast?
You could do the shield, couldn't you?
No, we don't have enough wood because this raft uses 2
Wait,
wood to do
why
it.
Why don't we have enough wood?
Oh, okay.
I would say then just discard it.
Right. Yeah, just discard it, I guess.
Yeah, I'm down for that.
Okay.
That goes up there. But next turn, we're going to have some meeples to use, so sweet.
Yay!
And now I'm going to roll for the fire. Great. Nice. I take another damage. And after the hurricane...
That's wrong, isn't it? These ones?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Okay. All right. Hungry Predator. While working, a hungry beast visits your camp. Get 2 hearts... 2 food, 1 fur, and discard this card, or discard 1 food and -1 palisades, and shuffle into the event deck. I think
can
I can.
You take? You can take the hit because if we've got extra food, we can heal you up, and we do get
And I don't lose any morale.
We do get extra food out of it. We actually get 2 food for killing it, so you can immediately heal those wounds back up.
Great, perfect, done. So I get 2 food and a fur.
And a fur, yes.
Okay, cool.
I kind of get the feeling that the fireplace is like a one action thing. I don't know why.
No. It's literally you can exchange food for it, and
you gotta... it just seems okay.
We're actually doing surprisingly well because normally it's fuck you city with this game. So,
well, we're approaching harsh weather because after the end of the next turn, we're rolling all 3 weather dice, and we don't really have a good house.
Yeah.
Well, we get a fireplace next turn as well. So good.
Yay!
That palisade goes up a level. Whoop. Nice.
And me.
Yes, your turn.
No, it's this.
So, yep, you get your grey, and then you get the brown. Yeah, the grey for the wood, yep.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, do you want to reroll?
Yay, inspiration dice. I don't think I can reroll.
Okay, cool. And then some brown.
Building as well.
Yep.
Oh, fuck. Inspiration dice.
Cool.
Never mind.
Now we do end phase stuff.
Oh, I didn't get my 2. Shit.
Now we do our end phase stuff. So, let's do some weather. We get 1 yellow. So, okay.
Cool. We're nothing still good.
Fuck you, bitch.
Nice.
Have a good roof.
Yeah, we do. I'm a good builder. So now we do food. All this stuff comes down, actually. Boop.
Oh, yeah. Raft.
So the raft's going to be very useful, actually. God, I'm trying to get this banana off. Give me a sec.
Get the banana off my raft.
So we all eat, so that's 4 bananas.
Yeah. We don't have to use the perishable stuff, so that's good.
And then the non-perishable, the perishable turns into non-perishable.
No. We don't. That was no.
That was the last piece of food. That was one.
There was
we had five.
We did.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Cool. And now it's nighttime. We don't want to move. Everyone's eaten, so we're Gouda. Okay. Now it's. Oops, sorry. Hang on, let me put that back.
I keep doing that.
Yeah, there you go.
I've locked mine.
Do we get our extra?
Yes.
No, the our event extra? The event stuff first happens first. So,
okay,
during the production phase, this round you get no wood. So we can't get any wood this turn.
In the production phase.
Yes, which is the stuff that's just about to happen. And weakness. Okay, so this is okay. This round, the first player cannot use his special determination skills. Put a blank on the first player's character card, so you can't use any of your skills. Oh wait, did you want to heal me during the night before this shit happens?
Did you want to? It's not me using it; it's you using it.
Well, okay. If I take 2 more damage, I'm going.
Well.
Yeah.
Eat. Why don't you eat like 2 of the food and heal up 4?
Okay.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Great. Done. Get rid of those 2 perishables. Yep. Perfect.
Done. And right, so I can't use any of my skills.
Yep. That includes your reroll, by the way, too.
That's rough.
So that includes your reroll.
Okay.
So yeah, what do you want to do? Oh no, everyone gets 2 thingies or a healing?
3, because we also get a free morale from the diary.
Oh, yeah.
3, yeah. Wasn't there another one in here somewhere?
Bye!
No. Oh, god damn it. I thought I had
just
it.
Say one!
There it is. I'm gonna just take my 3. Actually, I'm gonna take 1 inspiration and a heal. Because I can't actually use anything this turn anyway, so I may as well not be too concerned about stopping.
I don't think you get to pick. It's either or HP.
I get the heal from this, and we get +1 morale during the morale phase.
Okay. Oh. All right. No, that's fine.
When's the morale phase?
Now.
That's this now.
Oh, okay. So we all get another one of these.
You get 3.
Yep.
No, I'm going to heal myself.
Okay, yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, what are you doing?
Is this me now? Am I started?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm actually going to build a roof using furs.
All right. Cool. Yeah, that's
because we've got enough here to do two roofs just straight out.
Yes, we do.
So I think we're getting up to storm season, and yes, that's got me.
Oh, I need to move this. By the way, we're on turn six. Yep. By the way, so
we didn't.
Do you want to build? Do you want to build the mast? One, two, actually,
three, four, I was thinking that I can build the mast now as well.
What mast?
It's up in the
up here. Yeah. It costs us one fur and one wood, but we get three wood in the pile, which will complete this next row.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
So yeah, I'm nice. Gonna go for that.
But that gets it. We still have to spend three wood from our pile. It just means that we get that. No. We get replace that wood.
No.
No.
We spend one wood from the pile.
Yeah.
We spend one wood and one fur, okay. And we get three wood into the pile.
Yeah, but okay. Does that happen straight away?
And that or doesn't.
Yeah.
Does that count as how much we can put into the pile?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. So the way I see it, we're like taking some ropes and a bit of wood, and okay. We're like all right, making something so to cut the mast off the ship.
My turn. I'm going to. Okay, so we know that a parrot's going to come out. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to use this and use that.
Wait, where's Doggo?
He's down here now.
Down here.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm going to spend three of these, and I'm going to draw another five inventions, and we're going to pick the last slot that we can put stuff in.
So one... Well, the hammer and nails is gone now, so that goes away.
Does it? You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. One, two, three, four... five. Okay, so we get drums, which is just extra morale. That's kind of cool. We get a moat, which is two palisades. Fuck yeah, dude.
Lantern's an extra build.
A lantern is a permanent extra, dude. Yeah, for building. That's kind of cool. A basket is during successful gathering, you get an additional resource. Okay, so that's basically the same as the sack or a bow. I'm thinking the lantern might be very useful.
Yeah.
But I feel like we're getting closer and closer to not needing I think the basket, honestly, if I had to pick something.
Wouldn't the moat be important though, because we're only on two up here?
Yeah, but the thing is you gotta remember that we need more wood and we're not gonna be able to catch up to the wood demand. We don't
True, we can't get wood this turn, can we?
No, we can. It was just during the production phase.
Oh, just during production.
So I think, honestly, the basket is the way to go.
Yeah, I'd say basket.
Yeah, cool. That goes well with the sack. Also, I just looked through the rules. It does say that when you've gone through... No, don't put those on top there. Separate those into a different pile.
Okay.
So they go separate, and when you use the ability again, you search through the remaining ones, and you continue doing that as many times as you want. It does say when you run out of available.
No, it does. Because I've done it.
No, the bed came out last time.
Yeah, it does say when you run out, you reshuffle them and use them again. So I think you can go beyond what's on the thing.
Okay, cool. Right.
I'm not sure.
All right. Well, that's fine. And for my last dude, I'm going to put him on the basket, I think. Yep, that's me. Sheepdog, you're up, mate.
Yep.
Maybe you should spend some of your missionary points, dude. You're just fucking collecting them. What can you actually do?
He doesn't really have much he can do.
Discard two to stop all food from rotting in the night phase of the current round. Okay, we don't need
discard
that.
Discard two.
Okay.
To give you three.
Oh.
That's probably actually a really good use for him. He can stockpile. Holy shit, you actually have a pile of them there. That's not one. That's like five. Fuck.
You can only use that once for the round, though. So.
Yeah, but now you can use again to get a new idea if you want next time.
Yeah. I can reroll with the dude. So.
Yeah. Also that. Wait, I should probably give you more then. Sorry.
Wait, you can convert inspiration into wood for the pile. It says to discard two to spend a wood during one wood less during any action.
Yes.
An action of any type. So you could actually be using inspiration for free wood.
Have two more.
No, discard two to spend one wood less during any action of any type. That means it's during a build or something like that. But I have to, like, for example, this corral, I can use it during then and I wouldn't have to use a wood, right?
Yeah.
But that has to have a wood to spend. Like, for example, and that's only one wood. So if I were to build a wall, for example, it would only cost three. Yeah, it would still cost money. Yeah. So.
But being a corral, it would be no wood.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. Anyway, I gave you a crap ton of inspiration for it.
Discard one inspiration card. Any one character to give any number of their own to any other character they chose. Okay, so you could just fucking dump it on me. He's like,
well, I inspired.
Build. Yeah. Build. Good.
Okay. So what are you doing with your two things? Do you want to hunt, maybe? Yeah, wood. A wood?
I could guess I could hunt. But...
Yeah.
So... We are on
one. I'm going to...
Wait, how's that possible? Well. We should be on at least two food.
You used it to heal.
That was the previous night though, right?
Yeah.
So this is during the production phase.
Didn't we not get food? Oh no, we didn't get wood.
Yeah, we didn't get wood. One. Yeah, so
yeah, we still got food.
we still should have gotten our one food from here and whatever from the.
Do you want to just do a food from there?
Yeah, I'd say do a food.
Probably.
Because we only need one more food then, and then we're good. So.
I'm gathering wood.
Okay.
It may.
Okay, so I'm going
to... Peachy, Sheepdog, we have a free grey dude to help you, by the way.
Okay. Sure.
Yep.
So I'm going to explore with the free green dude.
No, it's one or the other. It's one or the other. So you can take the dog, for example.
I'm going to take the dog to hunt.
Okay.
I can re-roll anyway, so I'm going to go and hunt with Eldoja.
Okay.
Is there anything else I want to do here?
No, dude, you need to go up here and do it. You need to... Because we need
to... Yeah, we want the... It needs to be next to our camp for us to use the corral.
Yeah.
Like, all he does is explore. Right, yeah. He doesn't decide where he explores. He just...
well, I know which one's going to be next anyway, so that's pointless.
Well, you know what? Maybe it would be better to use the green dude on that because that way we.
Well, no, I can re-roll that.
Yeah, but I get that.
Nothing else to use the green dude on.
Yeah. So instead of the green dude being used, the gray dude, we can use the green dude instead. So.
Sheepdog's using the gray dude here, isn't he?
We need the corral to come out now.
Yeah.
We need the thing for the corral to come out now.
Yeah, so but I have a re-roll. I think we'll get it.
It's fine. Just do it.
Okay.
Shit. Hang on. I can't use the corral this time because Peachy has to fucking explore.
Well, you can always put it on the mountain here.
No, and it has to be a bird token.
There is a bird token there.
Where is the corral?
Here. It's a thing that I build, but I'm going to build first before you explore. Right?
Henny, there's a bird token.
Yes,
right here,
that's why we're adding another one right there, Sheepdog.
There's going to be a bird token right there.
We're adding two.
Oh, there's going to be another one. Okay, I get you.
Yes.
Also, I'm going to spend for scouting.
So the other option that I can do is I can put that guy there, and then I can go there and explore on my own turn, and then you can go there. Yeah?
Since I don't need to reroll, I'm going to scout.
No, don't scout. Because we've already got the parrot coming out.
No, he's scouting.
No, that's reconnaissance. I'm scouting.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So we're not building the corral this turn. Wait, no, we can. We totally can.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah. Except I have to explore that if that's going to happen. So
I guess I'll take the treasure. This gets discarded.
It's going to be something terrible, PG.
So flip it. Okay, unfortunate. Gremlins. Barrel. What's the barrel do? Keep this card. Use once during the night phase. Each player can heal one. After use, you can store up to two food on this card. Okay. Well,
this would have been nice really early, but we've got the cellar, so it's not.
Yeah. Not so bad. Except we just get a free heal at night, so that's not so bad.
It's used once, though.
All right.
But then you get the food after use. You can store up
All right, so how much wood are we putting in?
And the food does not rot, but we've got the cellar, so it already doesn't rot.
So we're putting 3 wood in the pile, right?
Yeah.
Yes. No. We need to keep at least 1, 2 if... wait, no. Yeah, because I'm using furs for that. So are you using your ability on the corral?
I will be, yeah.
Okay, so we need to keep at least 1 for me to do the mast. Other than that...
There's 3 wood in there, so...
Yeah.
All right, so you building the palisade, I guess, with 3?
Yep, palisade with 3 furs. I still roll on that, don't I? Because it is still a construction action.
Unless you use 2 dudes for that, so, which you didn't. Okay, perfect. Yay. So flip a dude.
Well,
so
take a perfect wound.
Discard 3 invention cards. Okay, so let's get rid of...
ones we've already got?
Yes. No, it doesn't matter which ones. So let's get rid of the pot.
And the dam.
Yeah,
pot, dam. Map. I don't think map's important.
Is that a permanent?
It is. It's a permanent green dude. So
that's pretty good. But I think green dudes, we're quickly going to run out of need for those.
So let's get rid of the pot. Let's get rid of these two as well then. Yeah.
Yeah.
So now there's room for more inventions to come out.
Yeah.
Sweet. That's actually good. That was actually a good thing.
So we got an extra roof. We're up to 2 now, and I need to roll for the mast.
Yep.
What? Are you fucking kidding me?
Reroll that.
How are you fucking kidding me?
Hang on, it says 2.
What the fuck?
It says 2. Okay, that's fine.
Yeah.
All right, so
come on.
Success.
So yeah,
okay,
burn
so that
wood.
Costs us a wood and a fur, and we get 3 wood in the
mast. No. I've already done that. We've already added 3 wood to it.
Yeah, but this is for the mast, so.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, okay. Wait, does that just add it to the pile? Is that how that works?
Yeah. Plus 3 wood to the pile.
Oh, okay. That's kind of cool.
It specifically says on there it's only for the pile.
So I spend 2 tokens to not spend a wood.
We need some roof shit.
And
because weather's going to get real bad soon.
It is. Yeah.
That's why I'm building
roofs
now.
Do the exploration first?
Yes, I will. Yeah, I'll do the exploration first. Okay.
Yay.
Perfecto. All right, carcass. Decide. Get food and a thing and shuffle into... Oh, wow. Diarrhea. I think we can handle diarrhea.
Each player takes 1 wound. That's only 1 wound. We could use the barrel if it ever comes up and just completely negate it.
Yeah. So, hang on, wait, how much do we get? 2 food.
Yeah. Two food and 1 fur. I'll chuck those in.
Okay, and 1 fur. Okay.
Goats. I love goats.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And I succeed. I also take a damage. Let me do that now. And I wonder what it'll be. Sweet, it's birdies.
Look, it's a massive junglist.
Are you saying that the jungle is quite large?
Yes,
and
the jungle is indeed.
Any jangling guy?
I just succeed with the corral then, so that's good. And now...
Wait, why am I here now?
So, hang on. So we put a black die on every one of those tokens on the birds. And
is it on all of them, or it says cover...
adjacent
on any tile adjacent, so that would be both of them. Wow. Yeah. Okay, so now I understand why I thought it was only for the one.
No, and put plus 1 food on the tile with your camp, so there's 2 more of these.
Yeah, 2 more plus ones.
Right.
You need to copy that twice.
I can't do it.
Yeah, I'll do it. It's fine.
Henley, you're the host, so you have to copy them.
Any jangling guy?
Ooh. Any jangling guy?
So that's why I wanted to do it, because...
Guys, do we really want to leave this island anymore? Because shit's getting pretty comfy here.
Yeah, no, it's not better than what it came from. So...
And the weather has been lovely.
Yeah.
Nobody's even tried to cut my other eye out.
I'm going to... how many are in this pile? 4, so... Okay, so the bow goes in there. That's fine. I'm going to... research again.
Because I actually happened in Portsmouth before.
Wait,
we
no,
left.
I've already done this. Fuck, I can't do it again. Yeah.
Have you been to Portsmouth?
All right.
Down there.
Yes, many times. They
okay.
have some great
Sheepdog,
museums.
You're up. So you got to roll the greys to it twice.
Portsmouth is full of slags.
I mean, everywhere.
I mean, it is.
Shit, everywhere is full of slags. Everyone's a slag. You fucking slag.
You slag.
I got inspiration.
You failed.
So you're not using... Okay, are you spending it? Is that what you're saying?
What? No. I won't spend it.
Okay, so you take a damage.
I take a damage when I'm
near. Winter is reducing the amount of sources on the island. Choose one source on the tile where you are gathering resources. Cover that source to indicate that it's exhausted. So... What, food?
Yeah,
it's got to be on the one he's researching, so yeah.
Okay, so one. We almost had perfect food, dudes.
It's fine, I'll probably be just hunting.
No, wait. I'm spending three, discarding three to remove the threat.
No, it's two, mate.
It's three.
Discard two to stop any character from drawing an adventure card.
That's what you're doing? Yep, okay. So now we get two wood, I guess.
Yep, because I'm using the sack. I'm using my sack, guys, to carry wood.
Crow goes up there.
Yep. There's an erection joke in there somewhere. Oh, fuck.
Okay, Peachy, you're up, mate. What are you doing?
I immediately my sex joke.
Who moved me? Because I don't have any money for a reroll.
I moved you, because I had to search.
Well, I mean, you were already exploring.
I had to explore, so that was what I had.
Well, he was exploring with the green dude, though.
No, yeah. I put that on mine so I can guarantee to get it. So
yeah, but you kind of should have told me because I spent money on inspiration, so I can't re-roll this card that comes out.
That's okay.
I can't re-roll these dice. That's what I'm saying.
No, I mean if you fail, you fail. We'll just exercise.
There you go. Perfect. You're good. So. Storm on the horizon. Another storm.
Another one? Fucking hell.
So you also take a damage as well.
I spend two. No.
One, two, three, I don't think four, I can do five. It before it's,
I probably should have spent it actually to stop the.
We're probably going to want some more palisade levels because anytime that storm icon thing comes up, it'll put a storm token over here. And then when we do the weather effect, it just straight up reduces the palisade by one or damages everyone.
It damages everything.
Oh, we got another river.
No. Storm token. Resolve the storm token after
shit.
Any
Hang
other
on, I get one,
storm
I get one
decreases
of those
the palisade level by one. If you cannot reduce it, each player gets one wound.
So that just increases the damage die block. So it's not
okay. Gonna, and then this can be discarded, right?
No, yeah, we're not going to use it. Yeah.
I increased it already.
And then I'm going to fight.
Fight that.
A puma.
So you take three damage, and we get two food and one fur.
But we do have the cure, so you don't get cat scratch fever.
So I take three damage, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Cool.
Did someone grab the food out?
I did. Yeah, I've done that already.
Cool.
He's got puma.
Okay, so that's the end of round. So now. Yep. We
got the Carl.
We do
Carl.
We put all these things in here, and then we do weather. Okay.
So we're still.
This is our last
turn of good weather.
Yeah, and then
it's our last turn of good weather.
Guys, do we eat?
No,
not yet. Okay. Weather first.
Okay, so two. Okay, we're good.
It's a good thing we've got that second roof. Hey guys, you're fucking welcome.
Okay, so now we eat, so let's take four nanas.
I got two.
Okay, I got the other two.
And these two will turn into permanents.
Yep. Perfect.
Fucking seller, bitches.
Seller. Alright, who's got the most damage? Peachy, do you want to eat a couple of nighttime nanas?
Do you want some banana bread to heal?
Won't we all take damage, though?
No.
No?
How much food have we got?
Dude,
plenty. Yeah, we've already eaten. We've already got extra food.
Yeah.
I'd like to heal because I'm just going to carry on hunting now. I guess.
Okay, so we'll take two of those.
One, two. Yeah, and I can go to max with two food.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, perfect. Great. And I think that's all we need to do at nighttime. I'll move this up. So now we're going to have three.
Inspiration goes after the event, right?
Yeah. So
we forgot to secure the camp.
What does that mean?
Landslide. there's no production phase this round. When the event comes out, it's gonna we're not gonna get any of these free foods.
Oh shit.
It's fine, Peachy's.
Peachy's hunting, so.
Yeah, Peachy, you go be the.
I'm gonna fight a gorilla next. I'm pretty sure.
Peachy fight that gorilla.
Because I'm pretty sure the gorilla was face up still, and it was like the second one in there.
No. So it gets shuffled. It's the gorilla's fight coming up pretty soon. So.
Gorilla.
All right. So yeah, we flip.
Nighttime banana.
Okay. Each player gets a thingy, and we draw another.
A wound.
We draw another one of these, so.
Wow. I shit myself so bad I injured myself.
Missed. Put a negative thing on exploration action field. Okay, so.
That's fine.
It's going to cost you two dudes to do that.
We got a green. We can use a meeple for that.
So what is the rest? Okay. This round, the first player cannot use his special determination skills. Okay, that's not so bad. So I'm first this round.
Yeah, so it's going to be me.
It's going to be you.
Well, that's it when it gets pushed off. So Actually, speaking of which, I can fuck my token off now.
Yeah, you can. Okay. I really like this game. This is so much fun.
Yeah, this is super fun. I like this.
Okay, and... All right, so I'm going first. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to...
Wait, don't we get
some nighttime bananas?
Yeah, no.
Morale.
So get three. One, two... I'm gonna get one, and then I'm gonna heal one. I think.
I'm gonna healing and then get a one. So what the hell is
I'm gonna take my one and heal back up to full.
The threat is this tiger thing here.
Okay, so I can discard. I can discard three to discard any card from the threat action.
Hang on, let me just look that up, because
everything's a threat. That's what they meant.
You're a threat, Peachy.
I am a threat to your virginity.
Yeah, like that hasn't happened already.
This is the threat action field here.
Not that hole, Sheepy. Not that hole.
Oh, I should have known.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Sheepdog. You suck.
It's literally on like the first page of the rules. It shows you threat action field, and there's an arrow pointing at it.
Okay. So I think what I'm going to do this turn is I'm going to basket.
I need to take my around thing, so I'm going to just take inspiration.
I'm going to use three, and I'm going to get me a helper, and I'm going to get the basket for free. And that'll help us get wood. Though I don't think we're going to have problems getting wood. So this turn we can only put one wood in the thing.
Yeah, and that'll complete it.
Yeah. So we're going to put one in. What else do I want to do?
Have you searched for inventions?
No. I'm going to do that now. Yeah, I'll search for inventions. So bow, wall, pit, belts, or sling.
Belts wouldn't be bad because we do need to scavenge for a lot of wood now.
Yeah, because then technically we'll have two of those helpers. The pit, during the production roll a brown die. And if you get a broken heart, you get +2 food. What the fuck? Oh, that's cool.
I think it's only usable once, probably.
No, on the back it's got it too.
No, if you flip it, if it just has the picture on it, it means that it goes away once you've used it, like the corral. We won't be able to use the corral again. Yeah. But things that have the actual icon still on them, they're things that stay.
Okay.
That's why I wanted to put that thing down there with the bird. I think the pit might actually be pretty useful. Because we would roll the heart die.
It's a shot at two food.
I'm going to be mostly hunting now, right?
I think we might have food kind of under control. I think maybe belts would
be better. Look at this. Look at the math, okay? We got three hunts left. We've got six turns.
We're also producing three food a turn right here.
And I'm hunting, so there's always going to be some food regardless of what happens.
Okay, well...
And this helper means that we'll always have... either two, or we'll have a spare green always, instead of having to choose.
What about a bow, then? Or the wall.
The bow would actually be nice for the hunting option.
Yeah.
That's true. Yeah.
If we're having hunting going on, a bow would be good.
So I do have health to spare, though, so if you prefer a worker...
Well, we're never going to... Okay. All right. We'll do the belt, I think.
Okay.
Yeah. No, I don't want to do that. Okay, there we go.
So that's all of those gone now, so you can, like, restack those and shuffle them together and...
Okay.
So is this the second edition? Like, there was an update, wasn't there?
This is the first edition.
DLC's right here.
Second edition just changes, like, a few things.
No, that's just a different scenario.
And so for my last dude, I'm going to...
No, it says expansion.
Yeah, but it's like using all the same stuff. It's just a different scenario. Like this one's the castaway scenario. Okay. This one is
guys. It's worth pointing out right now that we're going to be burning wood to stay warm. FYI.
No,
don't
we're not.
We have the furnace. But yeah. if more That's than true. One
and
comes
I
up,
can and I can make us some hooch to keep us warm.
Oh really?
I can turn cold into rain.
Okay.
With hooch.
All right then. Well, that's my turn.
Was hooch the first alcohol pop?
Fucking magic, right?
Yeah, magic. All right, Sheepdog, you're up, mate. What are you doing?
I'm gonna discard 3 inspiration to get rid of this.
Cool. Just put on the discard pile down here.
If you
hang on. Whoa. Why did you do that?
He has an ability. What?
You literally just discarded your inspiration to give you the chance to use your inspiration next turn, which you're not gonna have any.
Discard 3 to discard any...
Save it for this one, GP.
Any card from the threat action... No, he can remove that one right now. Like, he can...
No, this side is the threat action field.
Well, yeah, but next time I'll draw 3 inspiration and then I can do it again.
Oh, no, actually, no, you're right. Sorry, it is both sides. The picture's split and the arrow
I'd say get rid of this one, GP.
I can get rid of that one next time.
Okay.
That's fine. All right, so what are you doing with your tokens? You're just hunting for wood?
I'm gonna
keep in mind we have no food, so
I'm gonna be hunting.
Okay.
So get wood and I'll try.
So shall I use this?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, use that guy.
We don't wanna be
I mean we have the gatherer, we may as well gather.
Yeah.
Man, imagine if we didn't I think basically the dog has made this way too easy.
Yeah.
Honestly, but
it really does help a lot. Like, it doesn't seem like much. Like, we've got 8 meeples. What's one more going to have a huge effect? But it really does.
Yeah, it means you can split. All right, so, Peachy, what are you doing?
Hunting.
Yep. And...
Do you want me to explore, or...?
No need to explore.
Actually, hang on. Oh, no, we don't have the shield yet. Never mind.
I don't know what happens when the volcano comes out. Volcano. So, I know that's in there.
Yeah.
So...
Well, we could just stop where we are.
I don't think we need to explore anymore. But
are you sure? Okay, yeah. Then wood or hopefully this is going to be some.
Well,
food,
let's. We need 3 food at minimum, and the last creature that you fought. 3. Yeah. There's no, food. We're not getting 3 there.
No, we're not.
Production, right, man. Please. The production's been cut off, so we don't get that.
Oh.
But we still get 2 wood, so that should be like that.
I'm just gonna get more wood. We need wood.
Actually, we get 3 wood, yeah.
Why not, indeed?
Why
not get wood?
Okay, that's your turn. Doc, what are you doing?
Right, sorry, I was trying to figure out what the fucking volcano was. We don't really... Oh, we do have a couple of wood out. Should I just...
Maybe get the pelt? I don't know. You can help me with the palisade. Put one on there and then maybe do the pelt.
Yeah, I forgot. Do you need help though? Like, you're pretty good at building.
I can't reroll, so.
Alright, well let's just lock that in so that definitely gets done.
Yep.
Should I do this instead?
I mean, you can.
Like,
that is going to cost us a wood, but it's nice for the
hunting. No. So here's the thing. We can't because we have 4 wood right here. And that will be used for the palisade. So,
Why don't we use pelts? We've got a ton of them here.
Oh yeah, no, that's true. Yeah. So you can put.
So why don't I do this, and then that I go before Peachy, so that'll help his hunt.
Yep, that's fine.
Okay. All right. So for my second one, I guess
Belts.
Do we want belts? Do we want belts or shield?
Well, we've already got the... The dog is completely useless anywhere else now, so no need to get the shield.
Alright, so let's get the belts.
Yep, okay. And now we go to rolling phase. Do we want to put any... We can put one wood in here, which we will do.
Yep. That's done.
So now we need five more wood. I think we got this, guys. Maybe. We'll see. We'll see what the weather does to us.
I think we're doing quite well.
Let's see what the weather does to us.
We're at the point now where the weather is going to start really fucking us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is why we need to get off the island. You're wondering why, so here's why. Okay, so...
I really wanted to do the lost...
So this thing happens. So we got a basket.
Yay!
Remember, we've got a sack and a basket as well. So you can get... Yep. You can get four wood from just gathering.
Of course,
Can be used for only one action per round, so it'll have to be like this one will gather, and then this one will get it.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. There'll be four wood, so because we got two searches of wood, so and I guess this palisade just gets built then, yeah.
Yep, four, three furs. I'll move those out. We're not even making leather. We're just hanging animals on sticks.
Yeah. Scaring them away. All right, sheepdog, you're up. I guess this just happens. Done. So
and
you
I'll
get.
You'll use like the sack, so just get two.
Two, yep.
And then do I roll for this?
You
or...
do, yes. So you need to roll this. Okay, so you get.
Wait,
hurt.
Why is it? Oh, for this one, yeah. Sorry. I was going to say, why is he rolling, but.
And that goes up to three now, so...
Up to three, yeah.
Perfect.
And I get my monk back.
My monk. Peachy, you're up.
I got my fingers.
Driving my car.
So you can do that and that, so...
Alright, let's hunt.
Tiger.
Tigor.
So it does two damage to the stick after you take three damage.
Wait, does it?
Yes.
Yeah, he takes three damage, and then he damages our weapons by two.
So it goes down to one.
Okay. And we get five food and two pelts.
Yes.
All right, I'll grab those up.
Cool, cool. And then you roll for your gathering. So.
Let's see if we got some wood.
Yes, you get two wood from that. So.
I take one damage.
Can I suggest in the nighttime we do the barrel?
Why?
Because we all get one health.
Okay, yeah.
We are all a little bit beat up, so...
End of source.
Okay, so that was... You were...
Our shortcut is now fucked.
Yep,
that
so
was this one, yeah.
Yeah, so no more wood or food in there, so...
It makes sense. That's where we started and we depleted it first because we're humans and that's what we do.
Man, nothing makes sense.
This game is just fucking... Like, it's just sort of works...
It's mechanically well-made, yeah, for sure.
But if we all cross our fingers and hope for the best, we actually have enough wood to finish this already.
Maybe. We'll see. So go ahead.
See what the weather does.
Go ahead and make your roll for this build, for the pelt.
Yep. So...
Hey, all right. So you get one of those.
And it is...
Discard...
Is it of a predator?
Discard a banana.
Shuffle into the event deck.
Put in the weather space. Oh shit. That's kinda gross. What is there a attack die for that? What is that die?
Roll orange and resolve its effect. That's this one here, isn't it?
Yeah. Wait. No, I think that would be this one here.
Yeah, that's what No, that's red. Does it have a die on it?
Yeah, it has a die. It looks like a die, but it looks like a wolf head. I don't know what that means.
Yeah, this...
Can you look up Night Visit? Because Night Visit's the only one... So, the red die makes sense, because it's damaging everything, and it's got...
It's the hungry animal die. Where's the hungry animal die?
Hungry.
I don't know. I've never seen that die before.
It's not on here, is it?
Yeah,
because that's the no. This I'm sure this is it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Or is that the bad weather die?
That might be the hungry weather die. Let's check.
Discard one food, decrease the current palisade level by one. Oh, that's it. Yeah. So that's this is what it does. It'll either break the palisade or steal food or hit me for three.
Oh, okay, but we roll it twice. So, because we're rolling
that
now.
Fight a beast, and the beast has a strength of three if that comes up.
Yeah. Yeah.
But that's when this comes out as an event.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, no, that's the weather token. So when it's a weather space, so this goes in here, which is the weather space.
Okay.
Yeah, when we resolve weather. We're already doing that.
Yeah, when we resolve weather is when this happens.
Yeah, but okay, so did we discard a banana? We did.
Yeah.
We did. We did get the
1, 2, 3, 4, 5
belts though.
Yeah, that goes up there. Okay. So now we roll all three of these weather die.
Yay, weather die.
Here we go. Okay, so we get two cold and two rain.
So I can negate one cold by discarding three of these, and the it turns into a rain. So it doesn't just go away; it just becomes a rain.
Okay.
Okay, that's all right. So then we discard a wood for the extra cold.
Wait, what wood?
Because the
furnace negates a cold.
Yeah.
Oh right. Okay. Yeah. Fine.
So we've actually got three rain, which we're fine.
Okay.
And the hungry animal doesn't attack. So now I need to roll that again, right?
No. It's only when it comes up in the event deck. Because that's where it went into.
No, it went into the weather thing.
No. That was an event card. When it comes up, you add it to the weather die.
Are you sure?
Yes, that's what it said to do.
Okay.
So then that gets down. Now we eat these four bananas.
Eat bananas.
And we have one food left over.
How's everyone doing for health? I could really do with a heal.
I know you
can. Well, I said, yeah, use the barrel.
Use the barrel. So everyone gets a HP back, I guess.
Everyone gets a HP. And we could feed Peachy this for a heal, if you want.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
So that's three altogether for me, is it? One, two, three.
Okay. So that's the end of that turn. Now we move it up. Okay.
Stop stealing event cards, Peachy.
Sorry.
All right, Winter Depression. We move down an event track. Morale, sorry.
I'm just going to move that back up next time, I think.
Yeah. And now everyone gets two.
Three, because it's on two already, so we can also get a third one from the diary.
Okay.
Three for Sheepy. Sheepy gets three.
Okay. Now.
I'm first.
Yes, you're first. So, well, we do upkeep now.
I'll be back in 1 second.
So, before you do that, we get three food, and we get two wood.
Two wood?
Yes.
What do we get two wood?
Because there's a wood space and then a plus one.
Yeah. Gotcha.
And that's it. And now, Sheepdog, you get to place your workers.
I'm going to...
So this one is on the belt. There we go.
Get words. I take the belts.
Yep.
And then, do we just want more?
Maybe, we got a lot of wood, so we need 5 wood, so... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we got 3 wood left over. So maybe upgrade the weapon track.
Yeah. Sounds like a plan.
Okay. So that was spend 1 wood. Peachy, you're up now, mate.
Okay. I'm gonna go hunting
with the Doge.
Does anyone need the Doge?
No.
Nah.
He's only good at hunting or fighting, so. Hunting and exploring, so yeah.
What do we need most of now? Are we okay for wood? We're still not.
We'll be fine. We'll be fine.
What if something happens?
Yeah, maybe go for a food. Just
another food.
Yeah, another food.
I'm probably gonna fight the that gorilla next, aren't I?
Yeah.
Maybe.
So maybe I should.
Oh no! Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So you want to complete that 100%? That makes sense.
Yeah.
So you won't have to roll for that, and that'll go up. That'll go up to 2.
Is that worth?
Yeah, it's worth doing.
Okay. Also, I am going to discard 3 and move the track up. So you still got the option for health if you want it.
Cool.
Next time. Our morale has been great. I think that's why we're doing so good at the moment.
Yeah, it's because of that black dye that got put on 2 of them, I think.
Yeah, it really helps having that black dye there for you two.
All right, and Doc, you're up, mate.
Did you go below the your line?
No.
No, I've been keeping my health topped
up. Doc's not here, so we'll just skip him for now.
Let's eat him.
I'm going to put...
He's not even dead. He's just like asleep. It's like, let's eat him. It's like, but we got loads of food. Fuck it. Right?
I'm bored of all these different tropical foods. I just want to eat people.
Have you never played RimWorld? You just eat people because why not?
I have not played RimWorld.
Really?
I watch your... I'm going to let you into a secret here, Sheepdog. Your RimWorld series is what I go to sleep to.
Wow. Rude. I'm going to spend...
So I have watched so many episodes of RimWorld because I fall asleep and I'm like, where was I? Oh, I'll just go back here.
I'm going to spend
Have you seen Chelanophobia?
No. Is that...
I'm spending 3. Guys, I'm spending 3 to draw 5.
Cool. So I assume you've seen the one then with the fire.
Can you get us the weapon?
Yeah, the moat would be really good too.
Or the wall.
The moat or the wall? Actually,
no, if you're building the wall anyway.
Yeah. What about a TV? Can you get us a TV?
You've been eaten.
Maybe like a monkey butler.
We ate you while you were gone.
Wait, okay. aren't you advancing the track by 1 anyway?
Yeah, so the wall.
So the wall, we're going to get half a use out of that.
Well, you don't know that because the moment that the bad things happen, the wall's gonna get cut.
The lantern
in half.
Would be worthwhile.
The lantern.
Well,
I can
take some hits. 1, 2.
Wait, 4.
I can take 4 damage before I start morale.
Why is the gray there?
What gray? What are you talking about? Because we got
a good
point, and we got Ralph.
That's a gatherer, not a builder.
That's a gatherer, not a builder.
Oh, okay. So what are we getting then?
Well, that case, why don't you double build on this?
Yeah,
and then buy the palisade.
Get the moat or the wall.
Well, I mean, I'd have to build on the wall.
Yeah, but it's still, you can still guarantee the extra roof, and you can not waste the wall bonus.
Yeah,
if we decide to get it.
Oh, what about the lantern? Lantern's not bad. Getting a builder.
And this is like,
I think this turn you can get the roof up to 4 and the wall up to 4. So, I think that's a stronger
move. Here's what's going to happen, right? This rain is going to come down. We've got a plenty of fucking things in here that is stormy that will wreck things. I honestly think it's probably worth having extra builders to build walls when it comes.
Actually, we're not going to lose 3 roofs, even in the worst of situations.
Well, it'll go down. It's half rounded up, so it'll go down to 2. But if we go to 4, for example, it'll go down to 2. So that's what I'm saying. Like, either way, it's fine. But for every cloud over, we will lose food and wood and stuff. So, I don't know. Maybe the drums might be the best one then. You know what? Let's just go with the spear, I think.
Spear's nice. That's 3 meeples worth of actions.
Yeah, we'll go with spear.
Sure.
Okay. That's my turn. Doc, you got a place, by the way.
Right, sorry. Where am I going? What am I doing?
You're placing.
Yeah, but I don't really. Like, do we need
You can.
What do we need is what I'm asking.
We got a free palisade build right now. Because we got extra,
extra furs.
Furs, yeah. So
I'll do a palisade build.
Yeah, do a palisade build.
Should I put both of them on there, or should I grab the spear as well?
Double up, mate. Double up.
No, the spear's come off after your turn, so.
Yeah, the spear.
No, good point. So yeah, I'll do the palisade build.
Okay, cool. Alright, Sheepdog, you're up. So you do that for free, the gather, so you get 2 wood. Good job. Okay. And what was your second dude on? Oh, yeah, the stick. Okay, so the stick goes up.
Wait, what's happening now?
Do you have to roll for the stick? Because no, I thought I could move it up a second one, can't
no,
I?
No. Two no, people no, means that it just you're does just without
sure
roll.
It happens.
Okay.
What do you like, roll to move up the stick, though?
You don't roll anything.
It's a construction normally, but because there's two, you don't need to roll. You just guaranteed the
But
success.
It would normally be a brown.
Yes, it would.
Yes.
Gotcha.
So now you're fighting, I guess. So.
Okay, gorilla.
There you go.
Called it.
So you take 4 damage. It does. Actually, you take 5 damage.
He takes 1 less because the helmet.
So you take 4 damage then.
1, 2, 3.
No. That goes all the way to 0.
We got a knife. It goes to the.
No. We've talked about this. It goes all the way to 0 now.
No. We've got the knife. We talked about this. We've got the knife.
Yeah, but remember, see how it when it flips. It's not like we get 1 plus palisade.
We keep the knife as a usable thing, so like we can still make the spear because we still have a knife.
Yeah,
but we lost that extra. Yeah, we lost that extra fight that we got from having a knife.
Okay, so I see.
We get 5 right. bananas. So... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and how many things? 2.
And after the fight, I get a discovery token.
He's wearing a necklace.
He discovers he gets
two food. I told you I gave him two.
It was a she and she was pregnant.
Oh God, Doc, please.
All right. Why would you do that?
Mean.
So Doc, you just do a palisade.
Well, I mean, Peachy, you're the one who
And that costs a pack of 3 duders, so Baby I'll put that murderer. Back in there. And then my turn goes, and I make this go up. It costs me a pack of 3 duders. Yeah, we're cruising through this game now.
I mean, we can end it.
3. Next turn. 2 turns from now, so.
Why 2 turns from now?
Because we gotta finish this turn. And then we gotta get to turn.
Oh, we have to actually reach the end of the thing. Okay, yeah. I thought we just had, as soon as we got that done, it was finished.
Nope. And yeah, that's nighttime phase now. Oh, I know. We can put 5 logs up there, so we'll do that. Boom. That's all the logs we need.
All damn logs.
All the logs we need.
Yep. And so now we don't have to worry about much. So
it's just survive for a couple of turns.
So let's do some weather.
Let's see that weather.
Okay, palisade breaks. We don't need, you don't need to burn anything because we only have 1 cold and we're good.
And it's 1 rain, so we're good.
So what were we at? We were at 3, so it goes down.
We were at
up.
3.
No, I moved it down.
It doesn't just move down, it breaks in half though, so.
No, it reduces by 1 on that.
Oh, it
decrease the current palisade level by 1.
Okay, cool.
So it's 3.
All right, now we move the phase up. All right. Now, it is Peachy's turn first up.
Don't we eat and all that stuff now?
Yeah, yes, we do. Sorry. I'll just take 4 bananas. 4.
I would like to heal 1, 2, 1, 2. So 2 food.
2 more bananas. 2 heal. Yep. Anyone else want to heal? I could heal 1. I'm going to heal 1.
I think I'm fine.
I heal 1.
Is it inspiration now?
Does the missionary want to heal?
No, I'm good.
Okay, so I'll change these 3 bananas into sweet banana breads.
2 banana breads!
And I'm going to choose to heal 1 up to 4 and take my diary thing.
All right, and now you do your diaries.
I'm going to take the doge. Everyone good with that?
Yep.
Also,
wait,
really
don't we
need...
have to do this event thing?
Yes, we do.
Oh, yeah.
Well, basically, I'm just going to get rid of... Wait.
Okay. Yeah, so this is the night visit one, so you might want to burn that instead.
Yeah, I'll burn it.
Okay. All right, Peachy.
Actually, discarding one inspiration, it doesn't really hurt us that much at this point. We're gaining it pretty rapidly.
Yeah.
All right, Peachy, you're up, mate.
I need some fight. I desperately need some fight.
No, that doesn't go up now, mate.
It doesn't.
Oh, right.
Okay.
Can I take any of these to help?
No. They're gatherers.
Is it just a builder that does that?
They're gatherers. Gotcha. So
well, that's... Peachy, why don't you put it on the spear and I'll come and help you?
Yeah.
Because then you'll get to do that before.
All right, Doc, what are you doing?
I think at the moment we're kind of at the point where it's just a case of hunt and survive for a few rounds, right?
Yeah.
We're pretty good with everything else.
Yeah, that palisade could probably go up another level, but...
It's either that or I would up the spear.
I can come and help you up the spear if you want.
Okay, yeah.
Well, if you do that, because then... No, because that still won't go.
I don't think that's a very big hunt. Or is it the crocodile? It might be the crocodile.
Yeah, this will be the last hunt, by the way, FYI. Oh,
okay.
So you'll need to explore at some point.
Should I explore then? Should I do that now to try and see if we can get some more beast cards out?
Why doesn't Peachy explore? And then you just pick two on the...
We're at minus one. We're minus one to explore.
Yeah, we're minus one to explore.
We do have an explorer buddy.
Yeah. Also the
spear. Oh, we do.
So that would go like that.
And then Doc goes on top of the spear with...
So it's worth pointing out that you can only go two from the home base, but it's fine.
It's also worth pointing out that you won't get the spear for this fight.
Yeah.
So you'll have zero fight for this fight.
Yeah, I'm at full health.
He's at full health, so he should be able to take whatever it is, presumably.
Okay. So where are you putting your second dude?
I guess I'll also go... There's not much that we can really forage anymore. We kind of killed all the animals.
Yeah, you can...
Oh, there's a couple of fish.
So...
We don't really need the food.
Oh, wait, hang on. I feel like... Hang on. We're completely
missing...
We have
three here.
We're supposed to get three food.
And one, two... Two wood. There you go.
Yeah.
Perfect. So we're
three
okay.
Food.
We're
not
okay
four
with...
food. Three.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I got. Yeah. Three food. Yeah.
I was being...
Sheep was saying four food. It's like, no.
I was saying
all right, so I'm going to do that.
I was just joining in. People were saying numbers. I've
dysentery. Yes. Yep.
Okay. My turn. I'm going to go there. I'm going to go there.
What the fuck am I
going to
do?
I'm going
to
do...
Just go here, sheepy.
Spend three things. I'm going to get
you
some more
double
tech.
Down up here.
Can I go here?
No.
Why not?
So only two people can go look.
Ready?
Well, we do actually have a negative dude on the thing, so that will help us.
No, you can only do two.
No, you can only put two on there. Like.
You can put a third one on there.
No, you can't.
It's got a negative.
You can't. You can only do two.
It says one or two.
Yeah, one
so
or
you
two.
Have to do two.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, what happens if this stacks, though? Can these stack?
No, they can't stack.
I'm like 99% certain.
They can, yeah.
If this token is located next to an action field, that means that the next action of that type, you have to assign one more pawn than normally, i.e. two pawns instead of one, three pawns instead of two. Discard the token after resolving its effect.
So you can guarantee that exploit. The thing is, I've got a reroll.
Yeah, but that's the thing. You have to be the leader if you're the reroll. And if you go there, whoever goes last goes like on top of the thing. So then if Sheep goes there now, he'll be the leader.
Doesn't matter.
Leave it. Sheepdog, get the weapon up by one. Guaranteed.
Cool. So just so we're aware, the palisade costs four. And the...
Oh, I thought we had furs.
No, we only have two. And then this one will the weapon will cost one. And the spear will also cost one. So we need to pick.
Why not go gather some wood then?
Cool. Done. You got a gatherer here, so maybe you could... I don't know.
Maybe you should.
There you go.
No, maybe.
And we also still have the sack and the basket, so they'll both be able to get an extra.
Maybe you should hit subscribe on this YouTube channel right now.
No, don't do that.
This YouTube channel.
I wouldn't recommend it.
This one.
All right. Peachy, shut up and roll.
Wow. Do you want to kill this thing? No, I'm gonna fight first.
Oh, look at that.
Tapir.
So you take a total of 4 damage.
No, got the helmet.
And then it goes down to 3
damage. So you get beat up by a pig.
And we get
it surprised me.
We get two food and one.
It made a loud noise and you stumbled and
great.
You banged your shin on a coffee
table.
Didn't
get much food out of that.
No, it's fine though.
Still enough.
A land tile. Can somebody pick up my thing? Ooh.
What does the volcano do? Do you know?
I don't know. It doesn't seem. I think it's just it doesn't give us anything.
It kills everyone.
It would tell you if it was bad. So I don't think it just. Just don't think it does anything. All right. So
guys, first things first. I found a volcano, but the more dangerous thing is I found a tapir and it really hurt.
Well, okay. Yeah, but you killed it. So you kill the volcano too?
This goes away and then that flips now. So yep.
Oh, I haven't rolled the green dice. I should roll that first.
Yeah, roll. Okay, well, you failed.
I will reroll.
Okay, so reroll just the thing.
Any green action dice, so I'll make sure we succeed.
Yeah, I can't find anything on the volcano either, because there's actually a volcano scenario.
So it's making it really
difficult to search.
Decide, discard this card or draw 3 mystery cards. Only resolve traps and one trap. And two mysteries. Shuffle the event deck. I don't know.
What do you want? Can just discard it if you want.
I mean, it's one wound. I think we can.
Yeah.
I mean, this is the thing: is we don't really need anything else. So
I don't think we need anything else. So.
Like, it'd be interesting just to see what you get, but at the same time, maybe we can just win.
I mean, what if you just like find something really valuable to take off the island with you, so that when we get back, we can not only sell our story for millions, you can be a billionaire.
I mean, I've got it all written down.
But I'm gonna find a trap anyway, so I'm just gonna discard this.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. And make sure you take a damage too.
I did.
Okay, Doc, you're up. So
we have a bag for this discard pile.
So
it's ridiculous.
Construct palisade. That's automatically done.
That's 4. So 4 wood goes away. And then the spear is automatically done.
Spear automatically done. That's 1 wood. I don't need both of those either of these things.
Those are
yours.
Yeah. And that goes up there. But you still get the bonuses of it going up. So that's fine. My turn. Nothing happens because all my stuff's already resolved. And now we go on to missionary. So you get 1 auto resolve, so you get 2 wood.
Wait, no, I had this guy too.
No. It's one or the other for the raft.
Yeah, but
one or the other. Guys. Yeah, and he used the guy to do exploring. So fine. So 2 wood. Succeed with no problems.
Oh my god, go in the right bag, you absolute cockwomble.
I mean, we don't need either of these bags, so just throw them in.
Oh, do we?
No. Okay. This top one is just other scenarios.
Now we roll some. Okay, so first things first.
Weather?
Weather. So roll the weather die. Okay, so lots and lots of rain. So 4 rain, which is
4 rain, but we're good. Yep. And the palisade goes down by 1.
Yeah.
And then we eat 4 food. 1, 2, 4.
Okay, and then that turns into a thing.
Banana bread.
Cool.
And then we get a whole load of wood.
Yep, and we have enough for a free palisade upgrade anyway, so.
Yay.
Okay. Now we. Now at the end of this. Turn,
I'd like to heal again, please.
No heals for you.
I would advise against it because we have exactly 4 food and nothing left to hunt.
Oh, right. So I'd have to go to a. If I went to this to hunt, does that just pull up a card, or can I fight it as well?
Nope. There's no monsters left to hunt.
Animals only show up when you explore, and it reveals an
animal.
So
guys,
card.
We just need to pass this turn, and then we win.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
So as long as we don't lose any of this food, we're fine because we can put the 5. Yeah. We've done the wood and everything.
And
so,
if we lose 1 morale, it's it's nothing.
Okay, so a new event happens.
Yep.
Oh, hang on. Lose all your food. First things first. So we get 3 food. We get 2 wood. And then we flip. Furs. If possible, during production phase of this round, you get 1 less food. Draw another card. Okay.
So
just take a food off.
We're going to get hit with all of these things now. All
right. Headache. I get 2.
Well, you have the cure, so you're fine.
Oh, wait. Really? Okay. Yep. And then that thing just
discard
goes away.
Get another card.
Yep. All right.
Oh, God. They're all coming up.
Seriously, we're going to get all of these
illness.
Things now.
You don't, if you don't have
it's anything, fine, okay. Check it.
We have the cure.
Okay. All right, remove. Okay, so that's that. That just
okay, so I lose my free reroll.
Draw another card. Man.
Jesus Christ.
All right, it goes down. 1. Morale. Draw another card. Okay, ooh. Which one do we want?
Palisade? Palisade, yeah, because the roof will protect us from the rain. The palisade will still protect us from storms anyway.
Jesus.
All right, Pirate's Chest was cursed. This round, each player has only 1 token available.
Okay.
Draw another card. The first player gets 3 damage or 1 damage if you have a thing. So who's
so
first
one,
player?
Am I first this time?
No, it's Doc. So.
Oh, okay.
You only take 1 damage, so draw another card.
There we go.
Okay.
That's weird because that snake was in my trousers.
Okay, so
my trousers now.
Yeah, that's it. That's all we do. Great.
Okay.
Okay, that was a fucking nightmare.
That was a hell of a nightmare. All right,
so everyone gets 3 of the tokens.
I think I've got enough. I'm just going to take a heal and 1 token.
No, you can't heal.
Oh, we went down a morale, didn't we?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
And Doc, you're up, mate.
Yep. Let me go with my inspiration.
Hey, what up, Prylor? How you doing, man? Good to see you.
There's not much we need to do, is there?
Palisade, pretty much.
Well, right, first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna discard 3 inspiration to gain a food.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna discard 2 inspiration to use that food to heal for 2.
Roger that. I'll just take all this.
Yep. Okay. I just don't want to die right now.
So you got 1.
I've only got 1, so
just put on the palisade, man.
Yeah, may as well.
Okay, my turn.
Done.
Palisade done. Sheepdog, you're up. You got 1 dude.
Oh.
You can't fight.
I guess I'll go fishing. Okay.
Good.
No, I should probably go with this dude.
It doesn't matter. Either one's. Oh, yeah.
Well, so, I mean, just in case we want to do exploration.
Okay. Peachy, you're up.
I don't know what to do.
You can explore. You got a doggo.
I've also got 1 of these.
Mm-hmm.
We're guaranteed.
And
yeah, okay.
Everything guaranteed, and then we're good. All right. And now we go into the charging phase. All right. So this happens. Go up a palisade. We take these away. All the furs. Yep. That was my turn as well. Sheepdog, you roll your green. You just get that automatically, so we're good.
So that's 2 food for us.
Yep, 2 food, and you just draw a thing, and you get
what did we find? Oh, it's a beautiful waterfall. Let's stay.
And we get a wood.
A wood.
Nice. All right. Rawr. So nighttime happens. Actually, the rain happens first.
Oh yeah, weather.
Okay, cold.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Yep, we're good. We're fine. Nothing happened.
Didn't even break a palisade.
And that's pretty much the game.
We did it.
A ship comes around, and we're like, hey, motherfucker, we got this huge bonfire. We light it up.
It's pretty fucking huge when you consider the amount of wood in it. Like,
yeah, it took us an entire year to gather that wood.
Yeah.
I still fail to understand why we built a mast and then put it in the fire.
No, we took the mast off our crashed ship and use that as wood.
Okay, that makes more sense. I wasn't aware we were on a ship.
Yeah, we built a raft to go out to the mast sort of thing. So, yeah. I like this game a lot. I think next time we won't use the doggo because that's easy mode.
It definitely did make it a lot easier.
I'd be up for another round of this.
We got really lucky.
One of the different scenarios we can...
Like, if you look in here...
There's like another 10 scenarios. Well, these are the expansion ones. There's actually other non-expansion scenarios over in here.
Yeah, so...
Somewhere.
Yeah.
What's the max players for this?
Four.
I mean, I don't know what this is, but it looks
cool. That's the expansion. So these are the ones that you want to look
Kong.
At. So.
Oh, I want this one.
So there's a Volcano Island.
Indiana Jones one.
There is... I don't know what that is. The Naturalist? It's like a Darwinism thing. There's Cannibal Island. There is Robinson Family.
No.
I don't know what that is. That's something that's based on this game, I guess.
Cursed Island.
And Jenny Needs Help.
Jenny!
So what's the second scenario? Scenario 2 is Cursed Island, so...
Yeah.
Yeah. The goal of Cursed Island is to build a cross item 5 times. Wow, okay.
Okay.
Yeah, so each of these things does different things, like the...
We need victory points as well. We need to count that up. There's a thing here. Victory points. 1 victory point for each heart, 2 for each skull, 3 for each roof, 4 for each pile, and 2 for each palisade.
Oh, is that per person? I don't know.
I'm not sure how that works, but that's a thing.
Yeah,
I guess it's maybe a personal scoring to see who did the betterest.
Yeah.
We didn't really keep track of that kind of thing, though.
Yeah. So. I think, honestly, like, we had the most HP, we had the least amount of weapons, we had the most palisades and roof.
I didn't even drop down.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think the only one that got damaged...
And I fought a lot of shit.
Yeah. So this is Robinson Crusoe. It's a fun game. Definitely a lot easier with the doggo than I thought it would be. So maybe next time we won't play with the doggo. But
yeah, I think it was good as a trend.
Well, it is recommended for a first time to do this scenario with doggo.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think we got fairly lucky with the inventions and stuff and like what we found. So that probably helped quite a bit.
We did have that one round where everything went wrong, but because it was so late in the game and we'd had everything set up, it didn't hurt so much.
Yeah,
I think that helped us a lot as well. We didn't really care about the objective for the first couple of months. We just focused on getting ourselves set up with a steady supply of everything else. And I think that's probably how you win.
The other thing that I think is interesting, I don't think that the diary gives everyone extra bonuses. I could be wrong there.
I didn't think it was, but you guys said it did, so I was like...
Remember, it just says plus one. Normally, this would be over here, right?
Yeah.
And it'd activate and then bang, so we get plus one. Who would then get it if that were the case?
Plus, you got to remember, there are 75 different event cards. No, there's 120 different event cards, and we only had 12 that we brought in. So there's tons and tons of stuff in here that we didn't do. And, you know, there's some in here that are focused around combat and all that sort of stuff. So it's definitely harder to see where the difficulty comes from. But I honestly think this is...
I think we just got lucky.
Yeah.
The doggo definitely helped.
So I've played this game before and I've been completely obliterated by... On this scenario, by the way, too. So it's definitely... It's definitely a game of big swings, in my opinion. And I think we got pretty lucky. It's kind of like how we played Pandemic. We're just like, oh, this is easy. What's going on here? You know, like... Yeah.
Okay, so I think I might know one of the reasons why we did so well.
Oh, yeah? What is that?
The morale tracker?
Yeah.
Only affects the first player. Not all players per turn.
Oh! Wait.
Oh, really? That's interesting.
Yeah, so first player would be able to, like, oh, I'll take 2 inspiration. We were tagging, everyone was affected by it.
Yeah, I mean, what did we ultimately get out of that? Like, we got new research,
I guess. A shit ton of inspiration.
We got new research, and that was about it, really. We got some rerolls in there too, but
yeah, I think that's that. I was just looking at the morale thing for the diary, and yeah, it only affects the first player normally.
Yeah, because that makes a lot more sense now.
Oh, the extra one, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, so first player would get a bonus one because it only affects him.
So we played this on easy mode. Next time we're going to get absolutely trounced.
But we know how to play it, so we can do it harder next time, right?
Definitely.
If you like this, guys, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to everyone, which is coming up next.
Yeah. And
so Henley, flip the table.
Oh, I get to do that now. Yeah, boy, I get to do that now. Mm. Feels good, bro.
Bye, table.
Bye. Bye, internet. Bye. We love you.
Why are there tire tracks in this deserted island?
Bye, Fugue.